the freestyle by Corey Holcomb and this bitch. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. I don't like your daughter, bitch. Ever since I saw the little hoe, niggas knocking on my motherfucking door.
Is Trina there? Is she coming out?
I say, hey, put that thing in that bitch's mouth. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. Going in my refrigerator. Every nigga that nut in her, somehow they hate her.
Oh.
Her two kids that she kept cause she thought them dudes was gonna give her fuck. But then they ducked out on her ass. Fuck that silly slut. Even though that bitch do got a big ass butt. But I won't fuck her though. Cause it's your daughter. But get the daughter out my face before the slaughter. I don't like your daughter, bitch.
Oh, I told you he had some shit.
Force is strong on these goofies. What in the fuck is you gonna walk in the house on your wife fucking with a motherfucker and talk for more than 10 seconds?
Can I have a divorce?
Yeah. That motherfucker was asking her, can he have a divorce, wasn't he?
Yeah. Can I have a divorce? Will you give me a divorce?
I mean, well, he was setting her up because he gonna go to court and shit.
Yeah, he wanted to get her to say that, yeah.
Yeah, well, he got it on camera. He lied and said it ain't nobody else gonna see it.
But she never answered him, right?
She was asking him to turn that camera off before she answered.
Mm-hmm. She was embarrassed.
I think it's fucked up when your girl bold enough to bring somebody she gonna fuck with behind your back to the house.
Mm-hmm.
Your house.
That is a lack of fear from fucking up.
We can fuck at the house. Just come on to the house, Nick.
Oh, people fuck around. Let's be real. People fuck around, but you gonna bring a motherfucker
to the lion's den.
I ain't gonna lie, that first one looked phony.
Yeah, that was probably.
I walked in with the girls.
That first one looked phony to me.
Yeah, I got it hidden.
We had one better than that, but they took it off the internet.
Why did they take it off the internet?
Because it was a black man. You saw his face, and the bitch knew she fucked up, and they didn't want to show the bitch looking scared. He didn't hit her. He didn't do anything, but. It was a good one, man.
So he caught her dead to rights.
Caught her dead. He had caught
he
her twice.
He had hidden camera or he walked in holding
her? He walked in. He caught her because she was using an app. Glad to meet up with the dude.
And the dude was there?
And I think he had information on her app.
Mm.
And he caught their ass.
Wow.
But
that's got to be so humiliating. I mean, to think that, look, you not only are you just going to go out and mess around on me, but you had to go to an app, too? Like, you just not even a dude from work or something?
By you being a lady, Darlene, let me ask you. Like that second girl caught red-handed.
Mm-hmm. Just sitting there butt-ass naked.
This main thing she's saying is, Freeze, what up, boy?
What's up?
Freeze here. Main thing she's saying is, turn the camera off. I mean, like.
That's kind of like a woman type thing to do. You know what I'm saying? You're sitting there naked. You're embarrassed. A lot of humiliation going on.
Can you turn the light off?
It's funny if you see she's kind of like bent over.
So I can talk to you? Can you just turn off the camera?
What we saw Freeze was videos where guys walked in the house on their wife cheating. And the second one, it really was funny to me because he was asking questions like he really was interrupting their shit in his house. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, people always talking about this and domestic violence and all this shit. I'm just saying,
but
I would be really afraid of what would happen if I walked in my house and it was a motherfucker in there.
Mm.
Right, but see that's why she's probably cheating on him because he's a pussy ass nigga.
You took the words out of my mouth, dog.
But that's what Corey said earlier. He was like, "Do you know how much disrespect she may have to bring this dude?
If a man was bringing another girl to the house and y'all live together, both of y'all go to work every day or whatever the fuck, I think he fouled too." You know what I'm saying? But I'm saying there should be a certain level of danger and common sense at the same time where a woman should be like, we can't come to my house, motherfucker.
Because
that motherfucker will tear that motherfucker up.
Remember that? Lionel Richie.
That nigga catch us in this house.
What happened with Lionel Richie?
Yeah.
Remember his wife? You can still.
Oh, yeah, he got beat up.
He ran through the screen door.
Yeah, she busted them. and beat the crap out of both of them.
Hold on. Yeah. Put hands on everyone. Lionel Richie's wife.
Well, his
ex-wife. Is she bigger than him?
She put monkey paws on.
But when you're naked and you're in compromised position.
I wouldn't give a fuck if I am naked. Ain't no bitch finna whoop my ass unless she got my dick in her hand. Then I'm gonna be like, hey, okay, you don't want to do that.
He whipped the girls, but he did, right? He ran through a screen.
He what?
Ran through the screen door or something.
Who did?
Lionel Richie.
Wait. Lionel Richie called his wife cheating or she called him cheating?
She caught him and a woman.
And he ran through a screen door?
He ran through a screen door to get away.
They were running in the night.
Somebody called him Lionel Bitchy.
Fuck that shit. If I get caught, I ain't going to run unless my girl got a gun. But then again, let me stop saying that because there's some crazy bitches out here. This comic in Chicago got this joke. It's so funny where he basically, you know, his wife catch him. And he joking, but I can tell it come from something he been through. Yeah. He said, I took off running. Old girl was like, what's wrong? He said, run, bitch. You better run. That bitch crazy.
Some of them will do
run, bitch. Uncle Ray had a joke like, right. Run, bitch. That bitch will kill you.
Yeah. Kill him everything.
And, you know, a lot of people would like to speculate all they want on how they think they would act in situations like that. But you can't call it. You could say, this is how I... No, come on.
Lionel Quickie.
When it happens
well,
in the moment.
Well, you know what happens with average folks. If you catch your wife with a big-ass nigga, you're going to talk it out.
You'll be like, hold on now. Now, here, look at here.
Right. If Booker
all
T...
I'm saying.
When I was a young man, this nigga, I think this was his girl, that motherfucker came in the house. They saw me on the couch. Just when I was a young nigga, used to hoop. That I saw him size me up.
Wait, was that her husband or just
I don't know who he was. Oh, I think it was her boyfriend. And then he started yelling at her. Because I was scared too, but I was like, that nigga can't whoop me. You know what I'm saying? It means something.
Right.
But you might meet a motherfucker who got a gun. And on top of that, I know little motherfuckers that'll fight anybody.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, I don't, you can't judge a man by how it was.
Nothing
his
at all.
If
Booker T from the WWE was sitting in the house, you're not going to go in there reckless.
Who is Booker T? That's my problem. I don't know him.
That big, giant black nigga look like,
man, let me tell you.
Look like Busta Rhymes, but
you
only really
big. You ain't
going
to fuck with them lightweights.
We coming for you, nigga.
Them lightweights. them WWS motherfuckers. Them motherfuckers don't get tired. Them UFC motherfuckers.
Well, they all shot up with a bunch of stuff, too.
They don't get tired. Right. You got to pop one of them little motherfuckers.
Anderson Silver. Nigga sitting on the couch like, what's happening?
Mm-hmm. What's happening?
Mm-hmm. Anderson Silver, the spider. Silver.
They gonna run when they hear that drawer open in the room.
What's happening, nigga? Oh, you bad. Whoop this. Click, click. Right.
But you know you can really beat their ass if you shoot them under the kneecaps, because that's not attempt murder.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
You shoot them under the kneecaps, then you can beat their ass while they sitting there.
Stomp.
But why don't nobody ever... Shattered. Look, I'm saying, so are you wrong for shooting the bitch?
Hey, you know what?
It's a crime of passion.
Honesty. In all honesty, it may be. Yeah. If you're going to go to jail, but how long you stay? Hey, you could have blacked out. It's all kind of stuff.
I love that.
That's why you don't mess with nobody's woman, man, in their home.
In their home.
Because that's a whole other level. You're going to jail. You might lose
your
life.
If you shoot your woman in
you
the kneecap,
might there's a lot of people.
I don't know if you can claim crimes. Yeah, you can
there's
claim
a lot of people that are in the graveyard right now because of that. A lot of people. Yo, man, exactly. Somebody does 2 years.
Justifiable homicide.
Man.
This nigga have everybody in here. Again. I heard on the show it's justifiable homicide, nigga.
Chris walk in, what's up, motherfucking this girl? What you doing here with my girl? Go ahead. Spit on the nigga. That nigga.
You're crazy.
This nigga to fly.
The grasshopper.
God damn.
The grasshopper.
Not
killer.
In my house.
What if you get called fucking Chris girl and he got a cold?
Oh no!
God! Furniture get the
kimono dragon bacteria
like
spit.
All right, gotta cut the AC on for 3 days and now.
You know what, Chris? You should just
Darlene be getting hers in though.
I was gonna say, Chris, have you tried sucking on tea bags? Like,
fuck.
Like some herbal, just herbal.
Medicated tea bags.
He need about 9 swole ass flies to hold his tongue up and let the air blow on it.
And if you do suck on some tea bags, you should chew them up.
It's like
chew them up.
Maybe
chew
a Listerine broth or some type of
heat up some Listerine
tea.
And sip on it.
That nigga eat pussy look like somebody fucked the shit out that bitch before he even do something.
Damn. Oh,
damn. Look, he had to laugh.
This nigga's mouth gapes the pussy.
Stop.
God damn.
Damn. Wow.
Fuck. There's some bad breath people in this world. It's girls.
One of
them. You don't like their head because of their mouth. I'm not supposed to smell your mouth up here, bitch.
Right.
It ain't her fault. It's just that's her. She got strong mouth glands. Her mouth gland juices. Do they sell that at Whole Foods? Mouth gland juice?
Man. Gland juice?
Mouth gland juice. I don't know.
Somebody said they should smoke a peppermint blunt.
Wintergreen.
That nigga chew on some Gold Bond tea.
Peppermint gumbo.
What do you put in that? God, that was just,
fuck.
Peppermint. Wintergreen.
All sweet shit.
All minty shit.
No.
Drink a detergent smoothie.
Who's that? Mark Dark Rizzo. Oh, I know him.
This Chris nigga going to the dentist and getting a getting a stool mechanism put in his mouth. It's that motherfucker talk. Just be like, whoa.
Okay. Oh, damn, Chris. We're having a breath moment.
When he hold his hand be like, no. He be, come on, do it.
Yeah. They tried to take Chris Hosses. They let him go. They say, hey, look what he did to my hand when I got to his mouth.
He's so stupid.
Spearmint soda.
Spearmint soda.
Oh.
Anyway, man. Chris.
Palmolive martini.
What the hell?
They say that nigga need a
Palmolive
martini, nigga.
The nigga under that said he need a Altoids implant.
Oh,
yeah. It's a good idea.
Hell
just
yeah.
An Altoid that don't never get smaller, no matter how much you suck on it. Just a
man.
Just, it's all right, Chris. Man,
it's okay, Chris.
I'm fucking with you,
being silly.
Trying to let you know too.
You need a mouth transplant.
Right.
Somebody dead just cut out
somebody
their mouth.
Somebody dead would be better.
Need a fan made with Ajax blades in the back of his throat. What? I don't know what the fuck that nigga. They need some of them scrubbing bubbles. Them scrubbing bubbles will be like, let me the fuck up out of here.
Oh, shit.
That'll work. Just put a whole thing in your mouth.
Oh, my God.
All right, shit,
okay,
Chris.
Yeah.
Damn.
They're terrible.
Sorry.
They're terrible. I know.
All right. My bad, Chris. Right. We went here, but we'll get back on that cheating shit in a little bit. We're going to keep the show.
All right, yeah, so we can.
From 8 to 10 today,
I
guess.
Oh, we're actually going to see what.
We're going to see if we can do this.
All right.
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 So I guess we might as well get to this part of the show that has grown more notoriety than in the beginning.
It's legendary.
The glasses start to come on.
Give me
as
time.
Lee begins, put them right on that nose part. Go
give
ahead.
Me time. Let me put
tip of the nose. On tip of the nose glasses.
These are not the ones that you stretched out.
I stretched them out. That's good when a man stretches some shit out, right?
Not the glasses. That means your head. This head is big.
Yes. Exactly. When your head stretches it out, that's usually a good thing for a man.
No. Not
loose
that.
Talk about bullshit shall begin.
Wonderful. Thank you guys very much. That was a nice intro.
Hey, Freeze, in that bag right there, would you pass me one of those beverages?
Sure.
Thanks,
G. Are you done?
We ready? We gone with the
snacks that you need to break out or anything? Then?
I don't got no snacks today.
What? Okay, this is not even right. We actually have to give you a snack.
I don't know why you're acting like them glasses going to sit that high on your face.
Stop, Corey.
Them glasses are going down. You want one, Freeze?
Some of the best.
Okay, are we just, okay?
Chris,
well,
please take one.
Just don't want no ginger ale, that motherfucker.
It's just a free for all. Okay, we'll just wait until
have
they
a chemical
all
reaction. If
his
we
ginger,
put ginger in
his
mouth.
Ginger smell.
You need a vinegar ale.
Right. Oh. All right, here we go. All right, on a very, very, very different note. Somber, very, actually. The videotape has been released of the surveillance footage that shows what happened before a retired NFL player, Will Smith, was gunned down and killed near the French Quarter on Sunday. Yes. If you recall, he helped the Saints win the Super Bowl when they won that last time. Anyway, he's retired now. Anyway, investigators are trying to determine if whether the shooting was just a case of road rage or whether there was some other motive, because there's some interesting factors here. If you look at the videotape, it's online. It shows Smith's car almost, to me, a lot of people are saying it didn't even hit. It didn't even hit this Hummer. There was a Hummer acting kind of strange in front of his Mercedes truck. And all the more surveillance is actually coming out, but the main one that they just released shows Smith's car coming really close to the Hummer, and then the Hummer just stops abruptly, and then his car comes real close to the back and backs off. Anyway, the Hummer right away is going to pull over, and Smith's car just drives forward. He just takes off, and then the Hummer just goes after him. So then a couple of witnesses say that the Hummer then followed Smith and his wife, who was also in there. And they said that the Hummer runs his car off, and then the shooter's name is Cardell Hayes. He's already been arrested. He claims, and his lawyer claims, that it was, he thought that Smith was going to pull a gun out on him. So he's claiming self-defense. His name's Cardell Hayes. He's arrested with second-degree murder. He shot Smith 6 times in the chest and actually hit his wife 2 times in the legs. It's a very horrific video. They show her being taken away from the scene. She's screaming, crying out because they have 3 small children.
Oh, man.
And, yeah, so Smith is dead now, and the wife is...
So let me get this right. Somebody chased him down.
No.
And said, I thought he was going to do something to me.
The guy in the Hummer claims...
right.
Yeah, the guy in the Hummer claims that, if you watch the videotape, claims that Smith's car... backs into his, and that he was going to pull over, and then Smith pulls off. But this guy chases him, and rams his car. Now, they've got witnesses showing that guy now, Cardell Hayes, rams Smith's car, because they even see the damages, and then they get out to have a talk. Hayes's lawyer claims that they have proof that Cardell called 911 and was actually waiting on the police's arrival. And then he claims that he thought Smith was going to get a gun
out
on him.
That's some smart shit. The bottom line is the dude was trying to get away. And well, you know he's a celebrity. Will Smith is a celebrity, so the motherfucker hit him. He trying to get away. That's why he probably just moved out the way and kept going.
Here goes the strange...
you said the nigga chased him, right?
Yes, here goes
that's
the
what
cat.
I'm saying. When you chase somebody...
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You know you got... He knew he had them things.
Self-defense, you're going to have to throw out the window when you chase somebody.
He got his wife with him. He's like, I'm not going to get out here and have this conversation. Mm-hmm. I'm somebody.
I don't even think
let
he hit
his
car,
Let me just get
really.
In the car and let me just keep going. Let me just bounce.
So here goes an interesting... followed him. Here goes an interesting connection. Okay.
All right.
So, strangely enough, there's a weird, either a coincidence or not. The shooter, if you look him up, because it's all online now. Ironically, the shooter's father, who was mentally ill, was shot back in 2005 by police during a standoff. You can look all this up. It's got his father acting crazy, and the father lunges, the guy who just shot Smith. His dad lunges at a police officer, and all of them, they shoot him, right? So this guy, Cardell, who just committed this crime, sued New Orleans and received 6 years later, like 100-something thousand, which people are saying that that's how he bought the Hummer. I mean, he's broke. He just spent all the money buying a Hummer. And he received like over $100,000. Anyway, here's the catch. The guy, deputy... is the one that this guy's father lunged at with the knife is friends with Will Smith. As a matter of fact, Will posted a picture of him with the deputy a few days before on his Instagram. Kind of a strange...
Well, that might be something that just happened, but bottom line, I wasn't there, so I don't know all the facts.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But I know when you chase somebody down in your car and shoot them, it let me know you chased him down because you had a gun.
Mm.
Right.
Mm-hmm. That's right. And you know, you want to come up with all this shit about whatever the fuck. Mm. When you chase motherfuckers down and you got a gun.
You Billy Badass.
That's what happened.
That's what you did.
And you know who it is.
Because you ain't going to whoop them.
Yeah.
Right.
Right. And why are you trying to go with the self-defense? That's ridiculous. You don't chase if defense is not chasing. Chasing is offense.
I mean, right. Like, people beat this shit. Zimmerman walked you through a murder.
Well, these are two brothers, right. So I don't know what the outcome is going
to
be.
On 911.
That's real.
These are two
somebody
brothers,
trying to
right?
use the police excuse. You not a cop, homie.
Mm. I mean, Zimmerman flat out said, the lady said, don't follow him. And Zimmerman said, fuck that. They always getting away with shit. And went and killed a little black boy. So that's why he played dumb. Because if you got money or the right people behind you, you can beat them cases.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But chances are, if you done sued the city and got paid, and you done shot a motherfucker that you chased down because you got a gun, you fucked up in the game, homie.
You are.
And you know more is going to come out
you
with his wife being alive still, so you know she's probably going to give her side of the story. And then there's a lot more surveillance angles that they have coming forth from the streets of different stores. Wow. That were, I know, it's awful.
I was in New Orleans.
Sad, though, man.
Very
sad.
I was in New Orleans at the French Quarters. Homie, I left. That it's shit crazy. Is wild down there, man.
Yeah, New Orleans is buck wild.
Motherfuckers, man, that shit is
and weird.
Hood than a motherfucker down there.
And weird. They sell garlic necklaces. Y'all know I'm telling the truth.
You be in New Orleans, and you walking around down there. Before you know it, you on a dark street where everybody ain't hanging no more. Yep. And you feel it. I was in that shit. I was like, man, I'm finna go to my room. I ain't finna be out here in this shit. Right. Niggas hungry out here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Right. These motherfuckers will rob your ass.
And them kids, especially them kids with their bottle caps on their shoes to be doing the tap dancing, that's a setup. That's a tourist trap. Mm-hmm. Boy, look at the way they tap. Blah, blah.
Oh, so sad.
Give me a wallet, Lane.
So sad.
I don't like going nowhere where it get dark and lonely fast. No. It'd be a crowded ass street.
Right.
You just be walking, all of a sudden, it'd be like, hey, what the sound of the music? It's niggas over here. I'm gone.
And then you hear that buzz.
What up, Woody?
Boy, hey. You done stepped in the wrong place now.
Right. This ain't Master P over here, homie.
Look here, Water.
Water. I don't fuck with that French Quarters. When I go down there, I stay in the lamest part. I stay at that little pussy-ass hotel where it's people who, you know, is tourists at.
Right.
Right.
Once you leave the tourist spot in New Orleans, that's your ass. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, I was stationed there. When I was in the Army, I was at Fort Post. I was all up and down. And New Orleans is gully, but they got some gully places in Louisiana.
And times, too. You don't want to be out there in the middle of the night. But man. Anyway, I wish their family, I don't even know. I can't even say well, because it's like, what do you, gully. Mom is shot. And anyway, I hope they get justice. I guess that would be the most decent thing to say.
It's the worst shit in the world, man. When you know what I'm saying, over a car incident, motherfuckers get killed and shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Whoever it is, it's fucked up, man. He the breadwinner.
Three children,
and he gone.
Yeah.
Over some fucking shit with a fucking car.
A car.
Rest in peace, man.
I'm not taking up for the brother because he played in the NFL. I'm saying. Whoever chased somebody down and shot somebody,
because
you got a gun, because it ain't nothing else to be said, motherfucker. If you didn't have a gun, the man wouldn't be dead.
Yeah.
It's real.
That's what happened to the motherfucker homie in Chicago who played for Simeon, the basketball player.
Ben.
Yeah. Mm.
Is that the young kid?
Yeah.
What was his name?
Ben Wilson?
Oh, yeah.
Niggas up at the school on bullshit with a gun.
Mm, see?
If you got a gun, homie.
He wouldn't have followed him.
And you just standing around in a crowd.
You looking for some shit.
Right, dog.
You waiting for some shit to pop off so you can do what you do.
Last time I was in Miami, they arrested this dude. He shot somebody on the beach. Now, if a nigga got a gun on the beach, dog, I don't think you should ever get out of jail. I really don't.
You were purposely carrying that. You were
what
carrying
the fuck
that
is you doing with a gun
right.
on the beach?
At the beach.
This nigga at the beach with a gun. Hold on, I'm going to jump in. Get the fuck out of here, nigga. You ain't even there to swim. You there for bullshit.
So that gun can't get wet. You right. out there ready oh. for some shit.
Some motherfuckers, man.
Yeah, man.
Uh-huh.
I don't even want to hear.
Oh, Benji Wilson. Oh, okay. Rest in peace.
He's a good kid.
All right. Let's keep moving. Anyway, yeah. Jeez. That was terrible. The release of Barbershop, as you know it, if you don't, it's coming out. It's called The Next Cut for this version of Barbershop. Comes out this Friday, April 15th, starring Ice Cube, you know, Common, Cedric Container, Nicki Minaj, Eve, and more. But not without some drama now. If you haven't heard, before we get to that, it's been 12 years, if you didn't know, since the last release of Barbershop back in 2004. I didn't really know it was that long ago. But anyway, it's been 12 years since the last one was released. And this one is actually getting a lot of extra attention because it was a lawsuit placed by Ronald Dickerson, also known as J.D. Lawrence. He's an actor and a playwright, and he's been claiming, only now I guess this came up because this next one was getting ready to drop. So he claims that all the Barbershop movies are a pure straight ripoff of his play called Scissors. Lawrence is suing Warner Brothers and Showtime, and in the lawsuit, he gives examples of the similarities, and they're very close, of all the characters, each character, the storylines, actually, and the location, which is Chicago. Also, it goes down to each one's exact descriptions. It's ridiculously close to me, but anyway, his play went on for several years. It toured the country. He's suing for $20 million, and he's seeking an injunction to stop the film for the release this Friday. So far, there hasn't been any response from the companies or Ice Cube, who's the producer of all the films. So I gave you his picture. There he is. Looks like
I don't know. Who is that?
That's him. That's J.D. Lawrence. You missed it. He just took it down. He had it up there. All right. Well, anyway.
That's him?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's J.D. Lawrence?
Yep. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, let me say this about Hollywood. Comedians, singers, whatever you do, you come out here to make it. In the audience, there are people watching what you do, writing it all down. Because...
Yep, no doubt.
I'm talking about, I know these motherfuckers, and I have no respect for them. I have no respect for them. So when people make claims about what happened in Hollywood, I'm not saying the producer or the director or whatever is the one who did it, because sometimes they don't know. But all of these motherfuckers who claim to be writers.
Be at the comedy spots.
Be at the comedy spots, at everything, watching other people's raw ideas.
And
they turn
jacking.
It. Into the TV show shit because they connected with the gay people. Because most of the writers.
You're talking about Hollywood.
Most of the writers are gay. Why is that bad? Because I say that. I meet them all. I see who gets allowed into the fraternity. Most of them are moist. Most of them are moist motherfuckers. And they sit around and they give you dap after you get off stage.
And they got 47 notes.
And they the
from
motherfucker wrote down everything you did. That's what Hollywood is. Motherfuckers be like, I'm a writer. I be looking right at him when he say that. Okay. I mean, of course, not all people, but I would say at least half of them fit the description of what I said.
Yeah. Soft tissue boys.
Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
Hey, man, I just want to tell you were out of sight up there, man. Right. How'd you come up with that?
Right.
Brilliant.
That was genius.
Yeah, man.
That was riveting.
Hey, you don't mind if we talk or pick your brain. Listen.
Right.
I think you want to get knocked out, fun boy.
Right, man. Why are you talking to me?
You never work in Hollywood. Exactly, bitch.
They filling you out. They seeing how you approachable when they come talk to you. That's why.
Exactly. Right. How'd it go? Well... Just scratch his name off the list. I know that's what he said about me.
He's going to be trouble if you take his shit.
I don't feel safe even standing here.
Right.
Let's go to the other club.
You got any wrestling?
I know comics, man, who have people in the audience writing down other people's shit so they can go because the pressure is on for them to be funny.
Sure. And you know what? I heard, and you guys are comedians. You could tell me this. I heard it from other comedians. They said nobody's material is safe because it's a race to whoever gets it to TV first. That's who
more
actually
exposure,
owns
more
it.
Exposure to it, right?
So whoever gets it and gets it to TV, then that's the guy who owns it.
Because right away people are going to break
it. Some the comedians have told me that.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something about whoever said that. Mm-hmm. That's a coward motherfucker.
Speak up.
Because some people, you just not going to fuck with them because you don't want to have to deal with that motherfucker in these streets when you run into him.
Later on.
You got to set an example.
You see what's the example, Freeze?
I'm not going to get into the example again. It's been set.
Right.
You set need to the reconfirm
example, didn't you? I set the example. But I will say this. You can't go around beating up everybody.
You can't.
No, you can't. No. You can't. Because your arms will fall off. You will not succeed.
Break all your fingers.
You will not succeed. Mm. That's how fucking bitchified the game is. The only way to combat it is to be constantly creative. Constantly. By the time these niggas is biting this shit, they biting. Nigga, I'm on a whole new page with some shit you can't think of because you haven't practiced thinking.
In the urban biting comedy scene, most of the niggas on top is hacks.
What is a hack? Explain that to the listeners.
A motherfucker who watches the next man joke and then they go on the road and do it.
Now look, bro. I didn't take your joke. Your joke is about a dog that gets chased by parrots. My joke about a cat gets chased by canaries.
Right.
It's like
it's different, nigga. Mm.
When you go and pay your money, and I love the fact that this internet shit is out now. This helps. This helps the original comics.
Exactly.
Say, this is me in 92 saying that shit.
Right.
Right.
One of the comics who got jacked the most, and I always say this, is J.B. Smooth. J.B. Smooth, first of all, he's non-confrontational. He's just a cool dude.
Yeah, he's very
What I mean?
Right.
This is the tall dude on, he's been seen around. He's getting his Hollywood run now, and I'm glad.
Yeah.
Because I tell you, J.B.
Earned.
This shit is even worse out here. Pussy motherfuckers steal jokes. And because so many gay people in the world now, they go hide behind gay gangsters. I'm just saying.
Hide behind gay gangsters.
Man, look, man. I remember when I was in motherfucking New York. Nigga, these motherfuckers got backup. The little hacky garbage motherfuckers who normally ain't shit.
They got security now?
Man, these motherfuckers show up at the show with a whole bunch of motherfuckers. You be like, why these niggas taking up for this nigga? Because they fucking, nigga. That's the shit nobody ever think of. Niggas is fucking each other nowadays. You know what I'm saying? If you look at all the shit that's in the news right now.
Man.
We ain't talk about gay acting motherfuckers. We talk about gangsta ass niggas who want some dick.
Oh, my Lord.
Bruh.
Talking about hell. Nigga, this
hell. They'll be like, Freeze, you don't want to give me a kiss?
When the devil himself got a TV show, we're in hell. Lucifer is on TV right now.
Shit, why you think he ain't been on TV?
Been on all
right,
TV,
well, let's keep going so we can stay on good time because that's what we're doing from now on. All right, speaking of your boy, Zoe, Kobe.
Yeah.
You know,
Kobe.
His last game.
The Mamba.
Last game is tomorrow. Anyway.
The Mamba, congratulations, Mamba.
We're going to be at Bass Pro Shop looking for new fishing poles.
Here we go. Stop. Okay, the price. Let's talk about the price for these tickets.
In on this girl getting fucked.
The price for these tickets to see Kobe's last game against the Utah Jazz at the Staples Center tomorrow here in L.A. Your average ticket, according to StubHub, is going for $997 apiece. But at the moment, the cheapest you can find is $700 if it's still available. Now, the court side's a whole nother story. Anthony Top Dog Tiff, who's a very good friend of Kendrick Lamar's and the actual guy who discovered Kendrick. Anyway, he just bought two courtside tickets for over $40,000. And we only know this because, and I gave you that, there it is. He posted, that's them at another game. He posted on his Instagram a picture of his receipt.
Word.
The seats are actually $17,500 apiece plus service fees of $5,960 for a total of $40,960 for the two. He captioned the photo on his Instagram by saying, "Hey, sometimes you have to pay to play. Worth every penny to see one of my favorites hit the floor for the final time. At Kobe Bryant one, one of the best to ever do it."
Boom. Word. That motherfucker going to be 9 for 36 tomorrow. So,
hey.
There we go.
Hey. Hey.
He going to throw up every ball in the place.
That's right. He deserves it.
Oh, my God. They're
going to ask him why
God.
You do that. He's going to say, "I'm innocent."
Five-time champion.
Wow.
Look at all the pictures when Shaq won the MVP. Kobe looking at him like.
If they only knew what Salty. I knew. Right. And one day they are.
We got to get rid of Shaq.
Hey.
He's stealing all of the glory from me.
That wasn't Kobe's fault. It wasn't.
What you talking about? What Kobe's fault?
Snitching.
The taking pussy. Wasn't his fault? Snitching. The shall I keep
why
going?
The fucking the maiden.
Hey, hold on. Hold on. Some of this is Shaq's responsibility too.
Uh-oh. Okay, fuck. Shaq gone now. Them motherfuckers on the Lakers is so phony. All the players be like, "Hey, Kobe." They can't stand that pussy. Thing. You can look at him and tell. They be like,
"Stop."
I'll be glad when he's gone.
They can't stand the greatness. Okay.
Russell going to tell on him.
Oh.
Russell.
They're going to have a tell on each other contest.
A tell on each other contest.
Russell and Kobe.
Kobe, these players weren't happy. They was upset when you said you may extend again. Right. I'm just going to tell all the inner workings. Mm. And those two got mad at so-and-so. He's just going to give them a daily report.
Rick Fox said his hair was better than yours, Kobe.
Yep.
And these three niggas are cheating on their wives, Kobe. Just a little bit of information.
I'm gonna take a selfie of me, and I'm going to have them in the background.
Lazy okay. T4K call him the dying brother.
All I know is if you take all that personal shit, that off-the-court personal shit, if you take that
you
away.
You want to go on to the on-the-court shit?
And we just do on-the-court. Nigga, one of the greatest basketball players ever tied
this motherfucker's so terrible now.
Kobe and put him back in like 19.
And then just
I say
stitch his jaw shut.
And he'd be dunking on niggas still.
They would be.
Kobe is so awful right now.
Because he's just, old.
They just give him the first quarter. They'd be like, "Shoot as much as you want.
Exactly.
And we'll try to catch up from there."
Here.
If I'm lying, I'm done.
Spot us. Spot y'all 22 points because Kobe going to take all the shots.
Kobe
going to
look like a mummy with all that tape on him when he get off of this motherfucking
right,
game.
Man. It's all right. That man earned to go out the way he going out. Did
oh,
he not earn
it? You said you're going to be there,
Zo, you're unprecedented.
Going? Hell yeah, I'm going. I got a ticket.
You ain't got no ticket to the Lakers game tomorrow,
listen,
Nick.
Man, I do. Uh-oh. First off.
You going to Periscope
I've been going.
Us.
Hey,
got
and
an
I
after
will.
Party ticket.
No, I got a ticket, nigga.
At the Savoy. Hey.
And I'm going to be there,
going
nigga.
Going to the Savoy after
saying,
the game.
All I'm saying is.
I'm not going to reveal my.
Just bring some of that. Bring some of that popcorn up here next week.
Marcus King might have a hookup.
Marcus King,
he plugged.
Yeah, he plugged. I don't like giving out my sources.
Oh, motherfucker, we know you got a hookup, Zoe. You
I'm up in there, nigga.
God damn it.
Last Kobe game, nigga. I'm there, nigga.
I ain't mad at you, Kobe, but I'm just saying, my nigga, you did some hoe ass shit, man. You ran Shaq out of town.
He did not run Shaq out of town.
Man, come on, man.
Shaq ran himself out of town.
Did he?
Good riddance.
I love Shaq. Shaq is one of my favorite players.
Shaq went and won rings in other cities because his presence makes teams better, especially back then.
I can't argue that.
Should have won one that first year.
I can't argue that.
But Kobe, without superstars around him, makes everybody miserable.
Hey, wait a minute.
Nobody says that. Because when Shaq left, what happened? They had to rebuild. They got lucky, too. Just like Golden State got lucky and got Draymond Green.
And we won two titles without Shaq.
They got lucky, and they drafted Bynum.
Listen.
Because without Bynum.
Bynum and Gasol.
No, with Gasol, they got their ass. Gasol couldn't even get his shot off against KG then when they played Boston.
Because I'm just saying.
Kendrick Perkins stopped Gasol cold-blooded.
Kendrick Perkins baller. When you got on defense, okay, big on ass defense. Body.
Yes.
When you got two 7-footers, Gasol and motherfucking Andrew Bynum. And don't forget, that second year, Gasol went off.
Yeah, because Bynum was back there.
Exactly. Come on, man.
He was able to clean up.
Exactly. And there's no team in the history of the NBA that did not win the title as a team. Zoe said, Kobe is a beautiful woman.
So you better not be at that motherfucker with a Kobe motherfucking sign. Say, I'm over here, Kobe.
Oh. I'm going to be over there with
farewell,
no sign.
Champ. Oh. Zoe going to be in the stands with no shirt on. Oh.
Can I have your jersey, champ? Uh-uh. No, nigga. Uh-uh. I'm going to be there to wish the brother well. Zoe going to cry when the clock strikes zero. No, man, you got to give that man credit. Oh, that man's one of the best players, man, ever. And you know it. You don't want to give that. You don't want to give him that? He wasn't one of the best players ever? Ever.
Yes, he was one of the best players ever, Zoe.
Thank you.
But he
That's
was
all?
A trick-ass nigga.
Hey!
And on top of that, if he playing with so much talent that they can't help but win, look at that Lakers squad when they won. They was stacked.
Look at the Jordan 96 squad. That was stacked.
Where?
172-10.
Where?
Michael.
That wasn't
Pippen,
no free agent
Rodman,
squad.
That was a nigga.
Can I say something? Can I say something that I know all you Kobe fans ain't gonna like?
Come on, man.
Them players got better playing with L.
No.
They got better playing with Mike.
I can't.
Nobody
argue that.
Got better playing with Kobe.
That ain't true.
They won in spite of Kobe, right not
now.
With him.
Let me tell you something right now.
Got better.
Let me name some niggas that got better with playing with Kobe.
Ass. Who?
That got rings.
Who?
Sasha Vujacic.
The fuck is he talking about?
Jordan Farmar.
God bless you.
This nigga's in here sneezing.
Them niggas was on the team.
Sasha Vujacic.
A sneezing name, nigga.
Sasha Vujacic.
Jordan Farmar.
What? They was just on the squad.
Even guys like Pau Gasol. Pau Gasol was in Memphis.
A star.
He was an all-star in Memphis, but he wasn't going nowhere. Came to L.A., got with champions.
That's what I said.
And rose up. Trevor Ariza got a ring.
Can I say something?
Name some more niggas on them teams that Shaq wasn't on.
Bill Walton, garbage-ass son.
Devin George.
Bill Walton, garbage-ass son.
How about it? Luke Walton.
This is what happened when you play with stars, nigga, because you ain't naming who that motherfucker had. Shaq was a superstar. The old man used to go get superstars.
Meta World Peace. Yeah. Ron Artest come to the team, get rings. You got to give Kobe that credit. If you going to give Shaq credit or you going to give anybody credit, you got to give Kobe that credit. Now, Tyronn Lue was on the Shaq teams. He was on the Shaq teams.
The Stack team.
Listen, don't forget, Shaquille O'Neal dominated the East, right? When the Lakers get to the championship, you look at the teams.
Everywhere he played,
he dominated.
They was championship contenders.
He dominated.
You
but
can't
what
say
I'm
that
saying,
with Kobe.
Listen, all I'm saying
Kobe
is
played in L.A.
Shaq Kobe years.
For a lot of years where they wasn't shit because they didn't have superstars. What?
My nuts got better. You know what, J-Biz?
All I'm saying is Lamar Odom coming from the dungeon of the Clippers.
Playing, Lamar Odom used to be able to play.
Playing with Kobe?
He was a
come
6'10".
On, man. Those dudes got better under Kobe's
they
leadership.
They get better under Kobe.
Come on now.
Lamar Odom and Dwayne Wade took a squad that wasn't shit to the second round of the playoffs. Huh? Am I lying?
He did do that.
I think they went to the – did they go to the finals?
Them motherfuckers played.
Not the finals. The conference finals?
People like to
Lamar
marginalize.
Lamar Odom was a star before he got to L.A. L.A. go get stars.
People like to marginalize Kobe's championships and say he wasn't a good leader. But I'm going to tell you right now, without Shaquille O'Neal, he got the Los Angeles Lakers to the promised land twice. He's got one more championship than Kobe. I mean, then Shaq. You cannot marginalize that dude's impact.
Why
on
you
this
bring
team.
Up Shaq's name like that? He got one more championship than Shaq.
Shaq is my nigga. I love Shaq.
He ain't get more than air.
No, he didn't get more than air. He did not.
Yeah.
But that's the closest thing to air we got
And Air even said that.
Hold on. If Jordan was like Kobe, he would have came and played with Shaq them. Because hey. Phil Jackson told him, hey, man, you want to come play? Because at that time, Phil Jackson, no, he had a whip. That's why he had Mitch Richmond and all them other motherfuckers who was raw. He was like, y'all winding down. My will, come on, boy.
Come over here and get these championships. I ain't mad at that, but I'm going to tell you like horses. This. Michael Jordan respect Kobe. He don't respect all these new niggas. He respect Kobe. You ask Michael Jordan, who can you beat in your prime going one-on-one? Could you beat LeBron? I'd kill LeBron. Would you beat Whoop-de-Whoop? I'll beat Whoop-de-Whoop. What about Kobe?
Oh, what the fuck is this nigga talking about? Ain't nobody ever heard this shit.
Oh, that's
Zobe Bryant.
Michael Jordan said that. He said Kobe might beat me because he stole all my moves. He might beat me.
He was being sarcastic, motherfucker.
That's the only one he fuck with of these new niggas.
Because Kobe held his dick so hard in his presence.
Oh, my gosh.
If Jordan pissed
Get that man his credit.
If Jordan pissed on Kobe, Kobe would be like, do it again, Jordan.
Okay, let's keep moving.
My knees are getting better. Keep pissing.
So we can stay on.
Got your mummy outfit on after you go.
We're doing good on time.
After you go 6'90" tonight, nigga.
All right.
Hey, you get that man his credit. I'll be there. I'm going to snap some shots.
Kobe, let me say this, then we're going to move on. When Kobe played nowadays, it looked just like when Magic played in that last All-Star game.
Well, that last
getting out his way.
Oh,
what? That's what it looked like. I wish you could watch that All-Star game Magic played in.
I remember.
That motherfucker Jordan was like acting like he was God, and that motherfucker went to the hole. That motherfucker, that motherfucker got that sweet juice on him.
Silly. They was probably allowing him to do a little bit more because they felt bad for him.
No. That is
Magic had that MVP
was.
Like I was killing him. They was like, no, nigga, you killing yourself.
Oh,
dude.
Stop. Oh, Lord. All right. Something interesting here. Neo the singer, the R&B singer. His ex-fiance and mother to his two kids, her name is Monietta Shaw. She claims that she's warning Neo's new woman, Crystal Renee, to be careful because he just may do her the same way he did her.
Any bitch named Monietta gonna talk shit about everybody that she fuck with. It ain't a stand-up Monietta in the world.
Exactly. What? She was on that reality show.
Exactly.
Hollywood Exes in Atlanta, anyway.
Monietta.
Okay, Monietta. So Monietta.
Hey, can you make the picture bigger so we can see her?
Which is
Monietta's on the right.
Let me see the hoe.
And then Crystal's on the left. So what happened here.
That bitch.
I'll show you some of the pictures. Anyway, what happens here is Monietta now is claiming that that she had her tubes tied for Neo and that they both agreed to do it. Back when she was with him, they were engaged. After giving birth to their second child, she ended up getting sterilized. They went in on it. He said, yes, it'd be a great idea.
Sterilized.
Hold on. This is the words she's using. And she says also that Neo said he would get a vasectomy as well just to show his mutual commitment to their relationship. Well, before he could follow through on his vasectomy, according to Mrs. Shaw, Monietta, Neo broke up with her 2 months before they got married. And she said he claimed to break it off and that he told her he no longer wanted to be monogamous. Then she quickly finds out that he's seeing the girl from his current video, and now she's pregnant and they got married. So Monietta is claiming that it's so wrong. And
he didn't marry her, right?
No, he broke up with her 2 months before they were going to get married.
And
they had two children.
She got her tubes tied.
And now it's sterilized.
So
Monietta equals dumb bitch.
And right. So she's saying with
and you're that, useless to the next nigga.
She's dumb
saying,
bitch.
She's saying dumb it's unfair bitch. because
now your pussy irregular.
He went on and got another girl pregnant who's he's married to now. He married homegirl right away.
Happy.
And she's claiming that it's unfair because now she doesn't have the opportunity to give someone else children from her.
That's what it is.
You got your pussy what they call that shit? You got some iron work done on your pussy. And now you mad because...
Bruh.
Get your tubes cut.
And
who makes that kind of dumbass agreement?
They could cut exactly. With,
you weren't even
cut
married
with
to
a knot
yet.
At.
They hadn't even gotten married yet, even though you had two children with them. But, I mean, I don't know.
So she's got two children.
By Neo, yeah. And they were about to get married, and 2 months before the wedding, this is what she's saying, that he broke up with her... And then he wanted to be, he didn't want to be monogamous.
Yeah, that's all hurt. This is. This is, we got to listen and deal with this. It's going to tie up courts. Because
boy, you took
hurt.
My womb.
Bruh.
It is reversible. I don't know. She's claiming that maybe
you
there
can't
might
reverse
be.
Sterilization. Taking
all my womb from
they
me.
They said sterilization, but they keep saying, reverting back to she had her tubes tied. So I don't know if she's talking, if it really is deep sterilization. If so, then yes, she can.
I'm so glad your tubes are tied. Mm. Glad your tubes are tied. So Neo can skate in you.
Neo. You. That's terrible. Anyway.
Well,
they have two.
Womb Raider.
Oh,
Womb Raider.
No.
Wow.
Scar tissue hoe. Somebody got scar Bruh. Tissue hoe. Her twat. Monetta.
Her twat.
Oh. Terrible.
Not
terrible.
The Hurt
it's
Locker.
A tubal litigation.
That's what it's called. A tubal litigation. That's what it is.
Wow.
Womb derailment surgery.
Oh, my God. She has two children. I mean,
she caught a Jiffy Lube getting that pussy rebuilt.
It's terrible.
Seal off.
And you know, this is the truth. You have to be the dumbest bitch in the world to think that your pussy is going to make somebody get their dick. Yeah. What's the word?
Open.
A vasectomy.
Yeah. And those are reversible now.
Those are reversible.
All of that.
So how do they reverse it? Do they open your sack up and hot wire that motherfucker?
Snip in the back.
They unhook your nuts and then they hook them back up.
Womb tomb.
They also saying that for your first story, they're also saying that Smith was rumored to have a gun too. So the investigation is ongoing.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be a lot.
Well, maybe he did have a gun. Yeah. I heard about that. I heard it wasn't fired or nothing. It was just in the car. I heard.
Mm-hmm. Now he could have said self defense.
No, he was chasing him, right?
How many motherfuckers? Right, he didn't pull out his gun. Obviously, because they say the gun wasn't fired.
Right. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The gun was in the glove compartment. His wife was there.
Yeah.
So she gonna know if he pulled out his gun or not, cause you can't hide that.
Her story gonna reveal a lot.
Since we talk we'll about see. That sucker shit again, leave that shit alone. That goof ass nigga had a Hummer and a gun,
and a vendetta, a Hummer, a gun, and an agenda.
You never know. That's
and a history from his family of doing sucker ass shit. And I don't know. I don't give a fuck. Fuck that shit.
Anyway,
back to old girl. What was her name? Mignetta.
Monietta.
Minion.
Mignonetta.
She's a minion of Neo's.
Very pretty girl. Very pretty girl.
Is she?
Yeah.
I didn't really see that.
A great picture, but there was a lot. That was the only one that I put.
Pretty girl, but she was sharper than a sponge.
That's too terrible. I know. Casket match. That's awful.
Womb casket match. The new video game, Womb Casket. Kids trying to live. They're climbing up the.
We call it a ghost box.
Right. They're climbing up the arteries, trying to stay.
Ghost box.
God damn.
Hey, we're going to start some shit called Womb Wars. Like Star Wars?
And
Wars.
How's this go? What is it going
to be? I'm on the leader. That's Star Wars.
Were they going to start talking?
Don't do it, Anakin. I have the high ground.
Right. That's right.
You underestimate my womb.
Right.
Strike me down, and I would be more powerful than you ever could imagine.
Terrible.
It would be a big Chewbacca womb.
Bitch get naked. Like, God damn, bitch, what the fuck?
We reckless.
It's terrible. I know, yeah. Let's not go there.
Oh, shit. All right.
All right. What them wounds with all the stretch marks around the womb? You ever seen them?
The womb? You don't have stretch marks that you can see.
I done seen bitches. I done had bitches with stretch marks on the inside of the womb. God damn it.
You can't see the inside of a womb, Corey.
You can't see the inside of a womb. Why you tell me? You ever been with these bitches before?
Stop.
That lady gonna tell us what we can't see, and she only been with her pussy. You don't know what the fuck these hoes walk around here dragging around the city.
Stop.
Womb catacombs.
Right. It's bitches with Ralph bags down there.
Ooh. What the heck?
Bitches got whole Food Mart bags.
Bruh.
Pussy.
God. Jedi womb tricks. Who said that?
God. Goddamn. All right. Womb looked like
bulldog's face.
Spoiled cabbage.
Bruh.
Kimchi.
Kimchi coochie.
Kimchi.
Oh, some really good coochie. Kimchi coochie.
Stop.
Really good. All the kimchi coochie you gotta get. Oh, don't worry about smell. It's good. Trust me.
Trust me.
Kimchi coochie.
Number one. Number one coochie.
Right, pussy look
you
like
don't it. Need a soy sauce.
Right. Orange chicken coochie.
Orange chicken coochie. Pit bull.
Did you say bok choy coochie?
Look at bok choy.
Kung pao.
Boom, boom. Kung pao pussy.
Kung pao pussy. Very spicy pussy. Butter your dick.
No,
you don't need chopsticks for this one.
Oh, you don't want to cool off of your dick. Really hot, really hot.
I had this one bitch, I'm telling you, her pussy looked like a fish eating a hamburger. That's what a pussy looked like. Just think about a fish eating a hamburger. Like, you know how they be like, because there was some lips on top of lips. I was like, what the fuck? This bitch's lips is like the alien mouth.
You fucking a bum passed out in his mouth from the side with a goatee.
Oh shit. Like, come on. All right.
Yeah, break, please. Yeah, please
fluoride in a pussy. I kind of miss it.
Yeah.
What is that? Mm-hmm. Egg drop cooch.
Oh, egg drop coochie.
Ew, Mongolian.
It's a very good.
Mongolian meat box.
Oh, snap.
All right. Hell
no. Mongolian meat box. That's a winner.
Number seven, happy family.
All right.
All right, well, we're going to get ready to take a break since D directed that shit.
No. Chris told me. Brett.
Hey, fuck
it. You see how she do? She
Corey's not feeling well. We didn't tell
him. I was saying break, but I couldn't see his hands because
it was fog.
Yeah, he put his hands up.
That El Nino juice.
He drew back nubs. I'm like, Chris, don't ask him if he's okay.
We're taking a break, motherfuckers. We'll be back. 51,
mouth has
50.
A permanent mist around it.
Heavy in the game. Guess I can't retire. Niggas ain't gon' let me, man.
I'm jumping on this jet, touching down in the Midwest. Fucking with that ivory, make me sparkle like Crest. Then I dip back home, swerving on 10 with a Colombian bitch. She in the Benz with green. Keep it in motion, nigga. Ain't no looking back. Plus, I know the plug. I'ma always keep that stack. Getting money, that's the plan. The only shit I know. Swiss are burning up with drove. My mind on cash.
Keep on rolling. Swiss are smoking, rolling. Down that I-10 blowing. Mind on Benji's holding. True with the tech chop slowing. Chrome it got me slurring. Fuck living life in a hurry. If I wake up in the moment, I got to keep on going.
Hey, chop chop goes the speakers. And pop goes the weasel. That's my desert eagle. I still fuck with more dick, cause the flow is lethal. It's hard trying to walk a right path. Temptation is evil. Motherfuck the reaper. A big fuck you to my haters. Know you listening. Fuck with that Shaq boy mob like I'm from Sicily. Bet you can't copy my style. My ish different. If I don't fuck with you no more, it's just business, man. I'm still pulling hoes, rocking shows, slamming doors. Medical dispenser, keep my switches sweet on overload. And if I wake up, thank God, then roll up. Pull up, it's time to show up, cause I got to
keep on rolling. Switch the smoking, rolling. Down that cotton blowing. Mind on Benji's folding. Screwing the deck chops slowing. Roman got me slurring. Fuck living life in the hurry. If I wake up in the morning, I got to keep on rolling.
I'm stunting on these lames on a daily basis. That's why when haters see me, they be making faces. I can put you up on game, take you straight to basics. Running through this easy money, amazing races. Got a bad bitch with me, shawty, bring her back. Rio Grande Valley on Greyhound, she'll bring her pack. Man, I'm trying to get this fatty out by any means. Make it whenever, however, I got many schemes. Wood, forest, glen, late night, serving fiends. Bring the bitch dry till her purse is clean. Screens all glowing. 84's poking, hydroponic smoking. I got to
keep on rolling. Swiss the smoking, rolling. Down that I-10 blowing. Mind on Benji's folding. Screw with the tech chop slowing. Chrome it got me slurring. Fuck living life in the hurry. If I wake up in the morning, I got to keep on rolling.
Don't got impressed nobody. I carry myself. Don't hate me cause I shine. Alligator bills going off like five bills. Big body looks swell. Crack still sales. Still grinding off the rails. Keep strolling, strolling. On that 45, hit it to I-10. Just came from 50.
Hey, stop looking at my ashy elbows and go to the website and hook me up and buy something, motherfucker. Oh, I almost fucked myself up, man. Hey, stop looking at my ashy elbows and go to the website and hook me up and buy something, motherfucker. Oh, I almost fucked myself up, man.
Chrome it got me slurring, slurring. Fuck living life in the hurry. If I wake up in the morning, I got to keep on rolling.
That's bro. There we go.
Tito, Tito.
I said, Pittsburgh be that land. Shout out to my clan. Brooklyn's got a plan. Hate, I block it like a spam. See, I'm always aiming to please. I red dot it like Japan. And I won't stop till the people hear my shit like it's my jam. Real is where I stand. Won't stop till I'm kicking the can. They pulling strings and drums. And this shit feel like a band. You fucking with a motherfucking nigga with a nigga head spinning like a fan. On the track like I be Charlie. And bitch, I think I can. Try not to believe in Ken. That shit I reprimand. Look at things like that Biggie song. Just give me one more chance. Bet they all ain't murder. I'm sorry, I can't hear ya. And they do not compare to anything that I pair to. I do not fear the terrors. Ain't going by fixing errors. It is what it is. And that's how I view my mirror. Plus, vision getting clearer. I tell them, check me out. Fuck about what you thinking when you know nothing about ya. Broke up with my drama. Fuck my baby mama. How the fuck you keep a nigga that wants to be your father to his daughter? But I'm doubting fine. Had to reroute the rhyme. Feel like the clock on the track. I'm running out of time. Let's go. Yeah. Got another one. Hey, Brooklyn.
What up?
Got another one. Hey, check me out, though. Got another one. And we ain't stopping till you motherfucking number one. Okay, I got a suggestion. To those blinded and infected, we divided, need connected. Cause together we your weapon, but that talk on manifested. Feel that thought to me's neglected. Rich people got that money, thinking that dollar makes it heaven. I'm just leaving a message, another song to my collection. Writing songs be my obsession, keeps me out of my depression. Boredom and distressing, hearing these lies of this oppression. Got machines that's making money. What the fuck is a recession? Don't doubt, nigga, progressive positivity in your section. Stop thinking that your life is so a wreck. Hey, be advised to it's televised. Won't be surprised, seeing sad that they telling lies. She'll beat they self as pride. Got another one. Hey, Brooklyn.
What up?
Got another one. Hey, check me out, though. Got another one. And we ain't stopping till you motherfucking number one. Right.
Is that what they call it, pimping?
That would be pimping.
See, that's the thing. Pimping has a negative type of... Yeah, when you say pimp, that means you're a bad guy. But actually, a pimp is a good guy. A pimp is brilliant. It's not easy to talk a woman into doing something for you. Ask all the guys at the child support line.
Off top. This is for them niggas that don't know how to pronounce it, but know what it costs, though. Shit, you can't afford it if you ask what it costs, ho. This is rapid as crossroads with me in it. Get my point across, though. Brilliant, never soft spoken. Brooklyn in this bitch like she was easy when I talked to her. As soon as you bought that wine, I just crept her from behind. What's your name? What's your sign? She knew the drill and took a hard look. Now she wanna skip small talk, my figures in the ballpark. Now my hands on her figure, finna change the way she walk. By the way, they call me the number one plural. All chalk. Do what you want, but you gotta know your role, though. How the song go? We don't love them hoes, no. Lord knows y'all love my bitch. Though y'all don't wanna hear, it's like a term of endearment. Forget about it like there's no tomorrow. I'll catch every bullet thrown at me, Mark Bavaro. Call me a dog, call me chauvinistic. Go all ballistic cause I called you bitches. Fact remains is bitches do exist. Some men, some women, it's an act that you commend. It's not a gender thing, no reason to be bitter. Cause the fact remains I know more bitches, niggas. So most of the time I'm referring to them. I know you keep asking yourself, will these niggas ever smarten up? Nah, nigga, you do everything that females say. Men being jealous, that's a female trait, but hey, do you? But if I speak my mind all the time, your feelings will be hurt. So prepare your self-esteem, I'm exactly what I seem to be. I hold my own weight, you carry a purse, meaning everything she says you believe to be. Boy, power to peace strikes again. Way before you notice them, they lining you up. Already in your pocket, calculating your ends. I tell you my best, Sean Leon voice, tighten up. He ain't gonna get you no ring dance. Rather be a rich man's slut than a poor man's only. When a woman's fed up, she won't listen to you. Man, I just can't understand these pigeon principles. My pop said, boy, don't try, son. You never understand there's something inside them that's not inside us. Consider this plug. I deliver the God honest truth. We call it loopy. Love. Love hurts, baby.
And I mean it, goddamn it. Put a couple up in your body, leave your ass where you're standing. I just know what I'ma do. Fuck what you would do. Custom pistol circle around my niggas' waist like some hula hoops. Sneak a nigga, beat him if he ain't from your set. Throw them bowls, kick him, hit him, chop his ass in the neck. I got the straps under the seat, but we gon' hit him with bottles. Cause West shot from a creeping hollow. Nigga headless like a sleeping hollow. We gon' sit back, watch him. He turn around, we pop him. If he bring it Anna to the club, we gon' drop him. You see the shotty bitches ain't the only ones that pop. Now take the speakers out the back and put his ass in the trunk like this.
Oh, is that why I heard that at the funeral parlor? That's what they were playing.
You was my bitch, but you checked in my iPhone. Now you're gone home.
Yeah, we got to get the caller's opinion, too, when we let the callers in. We
got to use
opinion.
Your imagination. That was a beautiful ballad.
Shit was
that
horrible.
They play at the funeral parlor.
Section Chocolate.
I heard that beat at the funeral parlor, I think, when I went to Miss Sarah's funeral.
Miss Sarah.
Yeah. Bless her heart.
You ever been to them funerals where ain't nobody really there but about 8 people?
Play the music again. Let's hear that. Let's
that's
hear that
a sad
one more time.
Thing, man, boy. Lord have mercy.
Let's get a little vibe up in here.
Man,
you gonna sing, Zoe?
No.
Don't be shy with it.
I don't sing.
Somebody need to do something. Shit.
You was my bitch, but your kids was disrespectful. You was my bitch, but you was after child support. But I got my shit clipped, bitch.
Why make a cut out of this motherfucker? You just can't do traditional music. You gotta say what's really on your heart.
You gotta be creative, right?
I hate when men make them songs, I love you no matter what ass bullshit. Tell the truth.
Tell the truth. Do a tell the truth song real quick.
That was
you
one.
You was my bitch, but your outfit was cheap.
Talk about what you've been through.
You was my bitch, but $10 gas money I won't give you.
Yeah, flip that shit. Upper house in the pussy. Oh boy, it was pussy. That's the only word I could think to rhyme at that motherfucking time. My boyfriend walked in, I started to run. My dick was still hard from fun. Her kids saw me dangling in the alley. Fuck, this bitch named Sally lived 2 blocks away, cause I don't give a fuck. Her mama came in, I had to duck again. Why people keep walking on fucking? I'm tired of motherfuckers ducking and shit while I'm trying to ski. Everybody know I fuck with me. About to beat Zoe and Bobby 3. I'm on the street. Hey, no, fuck it. That was whack. But that was freestyle, motherfuckers. I don't give a fuck.
No, you don't. I love it.
You need to make that t-shirt. We back, nigga. Can we come with another winner? I don't know.
I think so.
We've been hitting some good ones lately, yeah. But we gonna see. 5150, top of the dome shit.
I'm not in love, no. Girl, I just like fucking you. Bitch, stop saying it. Not in love. Girl, I just like fucking you.
Breeze, tell them what's up. Off the top of the dome.
Some girls get taken out to eat.
get rubs up on their feet, but that ain't you, boo boo. I'm just here to do the do. No need cleaning up the house. Just open up your mouth and get ready, cause I got some place to be.
Oh, please, I'm not in love. Bitch, I just like fucking you. Trying to tell you what you need to know. I'm not in love.
Not in love.
Girl, I just like fucking you.
Fucking you.
So talk softly to the bitch.
Girl, I just want.
You're beautiful.
You're beautiful, girl. I don't want to get to know your people. I just want to pound your mound. So can we? Can we get out?
I'm not in love. Girl, I just like fucking you. Girl, I just like fucking you. And let me tell you the dude, I was getting down. I come through late at night, don't knock on your door. I honk the horn and I yell, where you at, stupid hoe?
Yeah. Chris, we back.
Yeah.
5150 show with another hit on the motherfucking go.
Oh.
Made this shit during the break, bitch niggas.
Yeah.
Everybody got that old girl in their life that won't go away. Shit. Bitch be popping up and shit. You be like, damn, I don't even fuck with this bitch no more. Is she over here?
Hovering.
That hovering ass seen. Bitch, goddammit.
Right.
Hey, get the fuck on, bitch. We wrote a song about that shit, though. Let's get ready to hit it, y'all. Hey,
I done introduced my new bitch to my mama now. Her and my family get along. We built a wing. I done introduced my new bitch to my mama now. So don't be calling my peeps acting like we still friends.
Hey, popping up at family functions like we still together.
Oh, man.
Get your ass beat down like wintertime Chicago weather.
Oh, windy.
You know I don't fuck with you. Gonna get your funky ass on. My new bitch throat skills on point and she can ride this bone. Hey,
I done introduced my new bitch to my mama then. Her and my family get along. We're built to win. I done introduced my new bitch to my mama then.
They know her.
So don't be calling my peeps acting like we still friends. Oh.
Hey. Hey, yo, my sister is cool. My mama is too. And it's all because I got a brand new boo. We tied it in glue. We tried and true. Now tell me what the fuck am I supposed to do with my old situation, arguments and such. My new queen is here. She came through in the clutch. Now what with Tuma and Boo Boo trust? And now we hand in hand with respect as a must.
I done introduced my new bitch to my mama now.
She part of the
her and my family get along. We
built to win.
I done introduced my new bitch to my mama now. So don't be calling my peeps acting like we still friends.
Freeze.
Hey, yo, ho, you don't know me no more. Stop hearting my tweets. You better act like you know. Our shit been over. Abandon all hope. And I don't want to see you in person or Periscope. And I blocked you on Facebook, so bitch, scram. And hell no, I don't want to be your friend on Instagram. Go ahead, live your life. Leave me alone, I'm here with my beautiful wife.
Oh. Introduce my new bitch to my mama then.
Yep.
Her and my family get along, we
built to win.
I done introduced my new bitch to my mama then.
Beat it. So don't be calling my peeps acting like we're still friends.
No more drama from you and your baby daddy's war. Oh. I found out he is your old pimp and you were his old whore.
Oh.
You called Freeze Love phone asking up, hey, where Corey at?
Bitch, you know I don't know.
I'm at that club where them fat bitches dance. What's it called? Bounce. Yeah, I'm over at that.
I done introduced my new bitch to my mama them.
Mama them.
Her and my family get along.
We
built to win.
We
built to win. I done introduced my new bitch to my mama them.
Mama them.
So don't be calling my peeps acting like we still friends.
Get the fuck on,
bitch. Get the fuck on.
Get the fuck on.
Get the fuck on.
Get the fuck on, bitch. Why don't you leave me alone?
Leave us alone.
Bounce, baby.
Leave us alone.
What's the shit Rockwell used to say?
Somebody's watching me.
Bitch kick rocks.
This bitch is watching me.
Yeah. Peekaboo ass bitch.
Bitch, why you watching me?
Yeah.
Hey, bitch, please stop watching me or you gon' see me and D.
Hey.
Hey, that would be
new
cool.
New 50, 150.
You break up with your girl and they see you with D, goddammit.
That's an upgrade.
That'd make a bitch mad, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I knew the fuck is you with that bitch used to be with Ice-T.
Yo, what's up? This is Ice-T and I endorse D with the new nigga.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't have a ponytail?
No ponytail. Nigga with no ponytail. Niggas with ponytail. Real talk though, some of you bitches, when the shit is over, just get the fuck on. He ain't fucking with you no more. Stop acting like you cool with his mama. Bitch, it's your mama house because your mama trying to be cool with the bitch.
Your mama invited me.
What? My mama invited you so she could whoop your ass, bitch.
That's 100, nigga.
You're stupid.
Yeah.
What up, nigga? Another cut. I like that song. Fuck that shit. What's dude name?
In the headphones.
Yo, nigga, we back?
We are back.
We back. This week, we gonna rap. Fuck that.
What?
In the celebration of Kobe Bryant leaving the NBA, we have a song that is a tribute to him.
Retirement!
We're just gonna put it to you like this.
I ain't dissing Kobe.
Check it out. Kobe Bryant, he retired from the league.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, Ice-T boys. But, yo, Kobe, you were never a G.
Uh-oh.
Say it one more time. Yeah,
Kobe Bryant,
he retired from the league. Yeah, and even though you was one of the best scorers, you ain't never been a G.
Ain't never been a G.
I can't hate on Kobe.
Kobe Bryant, why did you tell that bitch in Denver booty smell? And you still went raw. I bet you didn't even get a chance to put your dick in the jaw. Kobe, what the fuck is you doing? The new dude telling like you was when you met Karl Malone's wife. You say, Karl tried to talk to my girl. Hey, fuck that dyke, Kobe. Right.
Wow.
Yeah. Even though he was one of the best scorers, the nigga wasn't a G.
Wasn't a G.
Kobe Bryant. Yeah, he retired from the league.
Yeah.
Even though you was good, nigga, you are never a G.
Okay.
Yo.
G to me.
D, what's up?
Uh-oh. Me?
Yeah, all go right. Ahead with that bullshit.
You know what?
Come on, D.
Hey. All right. I'm going to try.
D, hey. Wrote a rap. Fuck hey. That. Hit him.
Hey, Kobe. Yeah. It's time for you to go. Adios, muchacho. Later. Goodbye. I'll tell you why. You're not making them baskets like you used to, son. No worries.
Go ahead, baby.
No worries. You done good, but only on that court. Now, if you kept your mouth shut, things may be better. But they not, so grab your grandpa's sweater.
Oh, everybody dissing Kobe.
D got that little pussy ass rapping in those.
Shut up.
Sorry, D, that was your first time rapping.
I did. I tried.
B. Bryant. Yeah, he retired from the league.
Aw, man. We're going to miss you, Kobe.
Keeping it real with you, dude. Yeah. You were never a G.
Were never a G.
9 for 30 on the night. Kobe Bryant. Yeah, he retired from the league.
So afraid to go in on him.
I'm not going.
Told on niggas like a bitch. Homie, you were nothing like a G.
Get him, though.
You see God in my movement. I represent true shit. Stay down for yourself. I know you'll see improvement. Your girl notice me. My flow like Jodeci. Oh. I keep the toast on me. I'll keep her close to me. Could eat the groceries if she's loyal to royalty. Queen shit, king shit. That's forgotten shit. Ho shit, fuck boys. On the top and shit. They keep on popping shit, but they ain't stopping shit. I keep on rocking it, but you'll keep mocking it.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, nigga.
It's Kobe. He ain't
still
shit.
Yeah, I'm not dissing Kobe, nigga.
Nigga ain't put Kobe in one rhyme.
Ready?
Kobe. Can't diss Kobe right now, nigga.
Kobe
Bryant.
He retired from the league.
Yeah.
Retired from the league.
Mamba.
Where he at though? He wasn't nothing like a G.
Was nothing like a G.
G to me, nigga.
Kobe Bryant. Yeah, he retired from the league. Yeah. Caught that bullshit case in Denver, putting your dick in the dookie sleeve. Hit him.
I'm from the back of the basin, the foot of the hill. Grew up with mountains, and when the Lakers was real. Back when Kareem was dunking and motherfucking Shaq was punking. And now is the days of Kobe telling. And he done got a little fella and he got him telling. And I'm just saying, what the fuck is your legacy? No, wait, please don't tell me. Because that's what you do too much. Just shut the fuck up and retire, homie. And if you see me, act like you don't know me. Because I'm a Laker fan of yesteryear, way before y'all niggas was queer.
Oh!
Off the top of the dome. B. Bryant. Yeah, he retired from the league.
Come on,
retired
man.
From the league.
Damn.
Keep snitching on niggas. We gonna put some Magic Johnson blood on your knees.
Oh. What the hell?
Yeah. Kobe Bryant. He retired from the league.
Retired from the league.
When your wife leave, you gonna wind up with a bitch that look like AC Green.
Oh!
Check it out. Kobe, I'm not against you. But you told and shit. Now I don't win with you. I don't like the Lakers because of you. All that hoe ass shit that you do.
Five rings.
You shoot
rings.
The ball so much. You know it's
but
over.
What
Scott
about
put him in the game. I'm a clover. Get your pussy ass out the game.
You got an asterisk by your name, Kobe.
Yeah.
He got five rings, nigga.
Oh.
Five rings with the asterisk by him.
Yeah.
Kobe,
get your pussy ass out of here.
He retired.
Congratulations, nigga. Bang on these niggas.
Last game against the Jazz. What kind of shit is that?
You gonna diss the opponent.
You got to play a team from Utah the last day you play. Get your foot stands out of here, nigga.
Listen, this is my last game. I want a surefire win. I don't want any monkey business.
Okay.
A minister.
I want to be able to shoot as many shots as I can with no complaining.
And where's my little inside man? My new little snitch. Now listen, I want you to get a report of everything that goes on in the locker room. I'm going to get you a red phone. And anything that goes on, you go right to that red phone and come right to me. And we'll divvy up the tattles.
Oh,
hope you and Magic Johnson son get stranded on an island together. You'd be like, fuck it, come on.
And I hope he's got the big ass boots he likes.
All right, that might have been the wackest song we did.
Yeah,
but
it's terrible.
Yeah, it's
you
terrible.
Gotta have one whack. Don't act like none of y'all niggas' albums don't.
But
have
the Magic Johnson knees shit was good.
I felt good. Oh, Lord. Right.
Bitch looked like AC Green.
That was funny.
No, this was funny though. This was a funny one.
Yeah. Hey, even if it sucks, we win. Comedians. Now, if you rappers really put out a song like that, you'll be fucked.
And they do nowadays, and they do.
Right.
Shawty, won't you come my way?
Kobe, won't you retire?
So, are you going to have a sign out in the seat?
No, I ain't going to have no damn sign. I'm just going to be in the building, and I'm going to support the brother on his way out.
You're going to reach over the rail and say, Kobe. Shake his hand.
Good job,
you know,
Kobe.
It is going to be full, though. We're
going to miss
of,
you, homie.
Of attendees, of celebrities, probably.
Fuck, I wish I could go. Man. I wish I could go.
You know you want to go.
I do. I wish I could go. And I wish I had a barrel of tomatoes to throw in his ass.
What the Lakers game?
Wow.
Oh, you don't like the Lakers?
But man, you go to that.
Man. I go to the Clippers game.
So you like the Clippers better than the Lakers?
Hell yeah.
Okay.
Right now, the way the Lakers put together, who the fuck you going to go
cool.
see?
All right, cool.
You going to go see the telling show? Yeah. Los Angeles Tellers.
They the Tellers now?
The Leakers.
The Leakers.
The L.A. Leakers.
No, but you're right. It's like people have been going the last year or so just to see who's going to attend it. Like stars, you know what I'm saying? Like,
oh, that's from day one, though. That's a part of L.A. Let's be honest. Any place you go in L.A., that's what the audience is there. They're not to see what the attraction is. They're to see who's in
who's
the
there?
Audience.
Who's there?
I done been to Lakers games, and I ain't never go to my seat. Just be out in the motherfucking vending area looking at who out there.
It'd be some baddies there, though.
Yeah, the bitches, that bitch had your broke ass with that big ass booty get some tickets. I'm fucking somebody who knows Shaq, though. Bitch, you look fabulous, but I see the poverty in your eye. Bitch, you ain't supposed to be here. How'd you get here? Who did you fuck?
Nah, you see them. You see them. They be in there.
Yeah.
Sitting a few seats up from the bench. Maybe 4-5 rows up from the bench.
All of them look like, okay, I see why they here.
Yeah, right. Especially with what they got on. It's like, really going to wear that
to
a basketball game?
The little back tattoo usually be out.
Yeah. They're going to wear that.
Butt cheek shorts.
Oh, yeah.
From everything. And this is L.A., man. This is Gold Digger Capital. This is the college. This is Harvard.
I love it when they purposely get up during a certain time and you're like, what do they get? And they walk right past. They go behind the bench.
They got it to a science.
That's pretty funny.
They advertising that ass.
They be looking, trying to look important, like they there doing, bitch, you here waiting on dick.
I'm telling you, this is L.A., man. That's what they breed little pretty girls out here. When they be barely learning how to talk.
Say Laker, Laker. Right. Say Laker. They be video bitches who call themselves doctors later on in life.
Oh.
Shawty, won't you come, mama?
Put that little pussy-ass gun down.
If you see Porter's there, you know she finna steal a basketball.
Damn.
Stop it.
I'ma get that ball. I'ma scratch this dandruff
on
that ball.
No, but really, what do you think he's gonna do? I mean, he's still awfully young. You know what I'm saying?
Listen, he's only, what is he, 36, 37 years old? He's young as hell. He's worth hundreds of millions of dollars.
So?
He's got his whole life ahead of him.
He ain't gonna get no bitch pregnant because he like asshole.
Oh, stop, really?
That bitch in Denver said that he wore the asshole.
Colorado. Rocky Mountain High. Colorado.
Kobe, that's the only thing he passed on is the pussy. He'd be like, let me get that ass.
Was sodomy, remember?
Rocky Mountain High.
I don't know anything.
No, the court. You don't know
about
the
those
case?
Details. I don't know anything.
You've wiped that from your memory.
Man,
all I know is Kobe would go to court and then fly back to L.A. and score 40 points 2 or 3 weeks straight. That's all I know.
Yeah.
One of the greatest players of
all
time.
That's why you're dangerous. You don't want to look at the truth.
Hey, I just want to look at the basketball player, all right?
He fucked a bitch in the ass and didn't get a phone number. Any bitch you fuck in the ass, you got to get a number and make sure she's still your homie for a couple of weeks.
It's your homie. He didn't even know her. Remember, he had just met her at the
hotel. That's why you got to get their number. You don't fuck a bitch in the ass the day you meet her, you must have her number.
Messed up.
All I know is,
then again,
the man scored. I remember I was in Miami. Mm-hmm. You remember we went to Miami for the Super Bowl?
When you fuck bitches in the ass, it makes a different sound than when you go in the pussy.
What's the sound?
The pussy be like this.
And the other sound?
Stop.
That's the other sound.
Warning. Warning.
That asshole.
You are entering through an exit. Warning.
That asshole.
Oh, my Lord. Oh.
No, but remember we was in Miami.
That's the new shit for fucking niggas in the air.
Stop.
Ass sound like a dart, nigga.
Right, you ain't got to say shit. Whenever you're in the room and you know a nigga fuck people in the air, be like.
Poison darts.
Oh, so now you don't even have to use words. You don't have to say Koi nothing. You just don't.
No, but listen.
Koi's still cool, but like if you just, because people up on Koi now. Like, that's that booty flap opening.
Stop.
That Twizzler getting stretched.
That's terrific.
What the fuck is going on right now?
I don't know.
Like, why would you want to make those noises?
What?
Just get away from them.
Somebody called it queer darts.
Queer darts. When you sodomize a little boy, buddy, make a different sound too.
No, don't.
What, don't
Who are
do
you
it?
Talking about?
No,
I'm just saying.
Are you talking about, hey, buddy, buddy, hey, buddy?
What?
No. Play at your own risk. Turn from day one. Play at your own risk.
Rah!
People, let me tell you what you know. Play at your own risk.
What is going on? Oh,
boo booing blood on my face.
Oh, man.
Oh,
that's
God,
a harsh
terrible.
Charge, boy. And if it's true, huh?
Yeah,
what?
Run your ass through the gallows.
Yeah, niggas is talking about Bam Bottom, man.
Oh, yeah, we heard about Bam Bottom, man. I don't know a lot about
or
what
Bam
happened.
Bottom.
Bam Bottom? Bam got him?
Bottom.
Bam got him.
Boy
Bam
got him?
Got him.
Yeah. Yeah, it's fucked
play
up.
Play at your own risk.
Ow!
Damn,
stop! Quit it!
No!
That's fucked up, man. Yo, if that shit is real.
I hope that shit ain't real, man.
I hope it isn't, man.
God damn.
If it is.
Flies in their faces. They're living like Mike.
I know how the football players that play for Penn State felt when they found out about Sandusky.
What?
Not the coach.
Africa Rambada.
Africa Rambada. Oh, shit. That's fucked up.
Man.
You know what's crazy? I don't even know.
Hope it's not real.
I don't even know which one is Bambada, though. It's a group, ain't it?
Nah,
it's one dude. He's a legend, man. He helped start hip hop.
Now niggas said he helped start hip hop.
He started the Zulu Nation. He helped start hip hop.
Him, Kool Herc, and the Bernie Spear.
He's mostly known for the Zulu Nation. That's
Zulu Nation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's all about
Zulu
unity.
Nation.
Wait a minute, the head of the Zulu Nation.
I have a story about him in my book. He helped
Zulu
stop
Nation
that
is
fight.
Down.
He stopped gang
stop
violence
fight.
In
well,
New York.
Well, he stopped the fight between LL and Tracy back in at Flavor Flav's party.
Yes,
it's all in my
yes.
book.
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
He was on our show. He was on the Zo What show a few years back.
Aha!
When we was at RMC, he called in.
Anyway,
is
right, can we...
Africa Hambada talking about over here?
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm. Nobody called in and talked about hip hop and how you
set that up.
I think it was through the poetess.
Oh, the poetess! I could see her.
She booked him for the show. You know, and he talked about how hip hop was instrumental in squashing gang violence in fucking hip hop. I mean, in New York. So, I mean, I believe
there are people who can do a lot of good things along with other things that aren't good.
Yeah.
Because let me tell you something. If you fuck children,
damn,
you doing some foul shit, G. And any
foul.
Motherfucker tell
he
you that.
Foulous. I'm sorry to say the foul. That's bottom of the line, baby.
Yeah.
You at the bottom, absolute bottom of the barrel.
Let me tell you something about two men who decide to fuck around. That's different. Because it's two consensual
motherfuckers. Two grown-ass men.
Anything you take from a child.
And you ruin that child's life.
Man. You know what I'm saying?
And the people around that child.
It's like, hey,
it's a ripple
nigga,
effect.
What the fuck?
You understand? They can't ripple back.
Right.
That's fucked up.
I mean, once a kid goes through that kind of trauma, that's a lifelong healing process.
Ain't no
it's not something
healing process. You don't
never
heal
yeah.
when you get your asshole took.
By an adult who's supposed to be somebody that's supposed to look
right.
out.
Right.
If you get your asshole took as a child, you're going to always remember that shit.
Well, of course. But that don't, anything. I mean.
Because if you grow up and you don't get out like that, you're going to be like, man, but that one nigga. he hit me raw. I'm just saying. My language is weird, but it's true. Consenting adults is different. Like, if you fucked somebody in the ass that wanted to get fucked in the ass, that's a...
And they adults?
It's a stinky, beautiful thing. But you wanted to go there with that person. You grown. You be like, fuck that shit. I'm tired of this pussy. I want the ass. What's some that? Motherfuckers be like, I don't never want your pussy. I want the ass.
What's the sound?
Which one?
Going in the ass. God damn it.
What? What?
Oh, man.
What did he say?
Planet rock equals...
Planet clock?
Plant your clock. Plant your
plant
cock.
Plant your cock?
Rock, rock to the plant your cock.
Don't stop.
Mm. Plant your cock to the plant your cock.
Hey, buddy, buddy. Hey, buddy, buddy.
Roof. Roof. Get him on the roof. Roof.
Oh, shit.
Did you say get him on?
Your own res. Get him on the roof. Roof.
So Tracy and LL had a beef since you brought that up?
Oh.
Yeah. I mean,
to the break
if,
of dawn.
Yeah, if you were in, if you were involved, yeah, if you were deep into hip-hop, dissed, then you knew that. Yeah. When yeah. He,
I
when he,
heard LL
but it wasn't
song.
Quite like a disc. I didn't take it as a disc. I
well, it was
I
a compliment
was,
to
that's
you.
That's what I was saying. I was like, oh,
I took your girl, I took the album
took
right
the
home
cover.
To the bathroom or
yeah,
some shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, he jerked off on my picture or whatever.
In that record.
And then you felt complimented by that, D?
It was kind of cute. Of course, at the time, shoot, I was only 19.
Darlene, nigga, Darlene.
LL saying that about when I was young. Yeah.
Name
I was
of the
like,
record.
See why
oh
you
gosh,
and Ice-T ain't making.
Oh, stop. Oh, cut it
what
out.
Was the name of the record is To the Break of Dawn.
Yeah. And we
LL
never...
dissed. Ice Cube, Ice-T, Hammer, and Moe D.
All
in one record.
In one record, yeah. And then we were out there filming New Jack City, and then there was a big party for Flavor Flav's birthday. It's all in my book, the whole breakdown of it. Yeah. And it was very interesting, yeah.
What about LL?
What about him?
Well, how did they get into it? What was I don't know what it was about.
What,
you have to read the book, sucker. I'm not going to give everything
Well, give
out.
Us a preview. Maybe somebody will buy the book for
oh,
this preview.
And FYI, also, my book finally is coming out on audio by next week. So,
yeah.
So you can hear it.
See, D don't want to talk
voice.
About what the beef was about.
She don't even want to get that up.
Knows it. What?
Can
no,
we
but,
just get a little
okay,
nugget?
Okay, it was at Flavor Flav's birthday party. Everybody was there. It was pretty packed. A lot of people were there. Big Daddy Kane, you name it. Chuck mm-hmm. D, everybody. Anyway,
Dope a dog.
They were passing each other, and it was about to go down. Mm-hmm. Some words were said, and Bam got everybody together and took. They all went in a room, and it was like a round table. Everybody who was anybody at the party that was a name, you know, was in that room, and they were talking it all out. They hashed it all out, and everybody gave their own little speech.
So they was
going to
fight because they passed by
but
each
Ice
other?
Ice-T wasn't a battle rapper like that. Ice-T is like, I'm not finna fuck with you on records, nigga. If you say something reckless, Ice-T is the type of dude that'll come see
right,
you
right,
because
he's like,
and
you disrespected
talk to you
my girl or whatever. I don't know. And there was probably some...
L is more braggadocious,
so
and I'm rhyming.
Was like who old boy was just looking for beefs on wax.
Nah, LL wasn't looking for beefs. I think LL just felt like he was the best at the time.
And not only that, he's a little younger, and then he, you know, he probably thought, oh, this is kind of cute and funny to say or whatever.
Right.
Like, look, I'll get some attention. Oh, we got attention, all right. Because there's some people you just don't say stuff about their girl.
But that Break of Dawn record, go look it up and listen to it.
Yeah,
it was
I know the song. Mm-hmm. I'm just trying to get information by asking questions.
And in my book, I have a lot of photo collages. So there's one in one of the photo collages. If you look really closely, because there's a lot, you know, in a collage, there's a lot of photos. But there's a good picture that I took at Tracy when we were up in Oakland in this record store. And, of course, all the top albums at the time were out. And he took Ryan Paye's, which is the first album cover that I did for him. And he's got this hella grin on his face, and he's placing it right over LL's. So wow. I put that picture in the book. There's a lot of pictures that aren't out there that they placed in there so people could see. So
well, it's like this, man. When you have a girl and people know that that's your girl, they do certain things to try to get under your skin.
And mind you, you're kind of thinking, you're looking at it like who they are now, but they were mid-20s and late teens and early 20s because LL was closer to my age. Mm. And Tracy, Ice-T, was only like 27, 28.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so...
That's what's up. Yeah. I want to say like when you're young, you have energy that is misplaced.
You think with this.
Yeah, I said something about Rihanna, you know how I be going in on her.
Beautiful said, woman.
Without no makeup on, I said she looked like Will Smith's son with Down syndrome.
Oh, my God. Are you serious?
I guess all them Rihanna people found out about it, and they was
they talking, got at you?
They was talking they shit. It helped my followers, though. What
they got like, at you like that?
Oh, they was talking shit. That'll happen. Broke-down-ass comedian motherfucker. Rihanna beautiful.
Don't say anything
like,
about no.
Why you mad? Because yeah. When you say something about a bad bitch, like if you call a bad bitch ugly, people be like,
get the fuck out of here.
He's
right.
Crazy.
They was taking up for her. They was like, they called her when she wasn't looking. you made my point, motherfucker. You stupid motherfucker.
The girl is bad, though.
Who?
Rihanna.
She'll stretch her hat out, too, boy.
You know what? Wait, what? Oh, my Lord.
She will.
So don't let her wear your fitted
jacket. Oh, head long don't forever. Let
her. You can't, ever, she can't get ever. A fitted over her
Girl is beautiful, though.
I can imagine.
You say she can only wear snapback? You call
no,
her,
I
please.
Could imagine if you lined up a gang of walnuts, she'll just have a ball smashing them shits. Like, bow, bow, bow.
He's being silly.
I mean, he said all bitches beautiful, though.
So I don't say all.
Now you discredit Rihanna when you call her beautiful.
I don't say
we know what
all.
You mean.
Didn't you say POTUS was beautiful?
POTUS.
She's watching, though.
He's beautiful.
This nigga said POTUS.
POTUS is very beautiful.
You just said Rihanna's beautiful and POTUS is beautiful.
Yes.
So your beautiful level is what?
Your range is like 360.
Yes.
Huh?
There's a gradation of beauty.
Oh.
What is the gradation?
I'm just
understand.
Saying like degrees. There's degrees of beauty.
So he's saying that they're all beautiful.
Right.
There's
that's not a good they're
you
all.
Put them all in the same bunch. Whether
he's
you
a positive
or not.
Guy.
Not they're all
no,
beautiful.
Well,
they all have
about.
A beauty.
Mm. Huh?
They all have a beauty.
Oh,
he's
so.
Trying to fix it now, right?
Oh, it sounds better.
So it's now you ain't saying POTUS and Rihanna is beautiful. You saying POTUS has a part of your heart and Rihanna is beautiful. Is that what you're
no,
saying?
No. Hold on.
Because POTUS is going to be watching.
I see how you put that in there.
She gonna
let
send
me just
a
say,
text and shit.
If you pull up a picture of the POTUS,
stealing ass bitch.
She's beautiful.
Look. No. It's just like with Rihanna, though.
Attractive
if
woman.
You put up a picture of Rihanna, she going to make it a good picture. But I'm talking about that sitting around, watching the game, drinking the beer look.
Yeah, but almost nobody looks good like that.
Nah,
Jesus.
There's some bitches out here look good. Vomiting.
No, oh, please.
Be like, oh, fuck the shit out of that bitch.
Well, name one woman that look good like
hold
that.
On,
like
hold
that.
On, hold on, hold on, hold no, on. Fuck yeah. This.
Here we go
I
with
remembered
photos
you
again.
Did this shit.
You know what I'm saying? Here we go
let's
again.
Let's go to some photos.
Let's go to the photos.
Fuck this shit.
But they
damn
are
it.
What they are. Photos. So either you can get caught in bad lighting or you can have good lighting.
Ain't no
makeup,
lighting with some of these bitches.
Poses. Here we go.
Hey, you pull up your pictures. I got mine.
Hold on. God, I'm trying to do this shit fast as hell.
Tell me your name, horse master, and I shall tell you mine.
Chris, I'm finna send you some pictures, nigga.
Yeah, look at that pretty girl right there.
See, put she these has this bitches little lipstick up. On. Yeah,
that's Rihanna. Both them women pretty, man.
Man, goddammit, if you don't get that clown looking bitch.
Stop
I done told you they both pretty. You've been proved wrong.
Okay, well, okay, that's a nice makeup shot.
Rihanna, look at Rihanna. You see all the makeup on her? I don't see a lot of makeup on that woman.
No, just a little bronzer, a little.
Oh,
you
talking about
can
Rihanna?
Still see her, all her details.
This like, was so fucked up. POTUS looked better than Rihanna in that picture.
POTUS looked good, boy. You know POTUS
but
is attractive.
But she got all her makeup and shit. God damn it, that picture is sponsored by MAC. Mm.
You know what? Stop. You're so crazy.
What?
Bruh.
What? Y'all can say whatever the fuck y'all want to say. God damn it.
I enjoy looking at these pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Pictures of who?
Both these women.
So, them bitches is not
these
going.
Are the degrees of beauty that I spoke of earlier.
Look, that picture of POTUS with her makeup on and that mold powdered down.
I'm done.
What?
Oh, gosh.
Okay.
Go.
Bruh.
One day I squeezed it. It said,
oh, my God. Stop, Chris. Egging him.
Get
egging
the
him
fuck
on.
Out of here. Now, let's look at this picture of Rihanna. Let's look at this picture for real. Now, you saying that's a bad bitch right there.
I am.
A war.
That picture right there, though.
She out here lango way back, man. She out here way back.
Work that ass.
Oh, I love that song.
You can't even see her ass on
there. I got a girl look
that
like
woman. I'd see that woman. I'd go right to her and say, hey, how you doing?
Rihanna look like she here. Running hella fast.
That bitch looked like, goddammit. Hold on, let me think of some good shit for her.
She's ahead of her time. Of
course. Hey, why you guys always talking about her head? And everybody can't have not? A perfect head.
If somebody talk about me, what's the first thing
they
talk about?
She got a football helmet, but it's an attractive football helmet.
They call me Snack King.
That's right.
That's they true. Say something about me. They say something about I got a gut.
They say I got a shark
She face. Got a good head.
I got a fucking Arab nose.
Freeze, I get it.
And an Arab
they
nose.
Say I'm my eyes are too close together or I'm cross-eyed or something like
Listen,
that.
Listen, how many dudes in the chat talk about right Chris's now breath. Would smash both those women if they saw it? I guarantee you these niggas will tell you right now. These
niggas will fuck Candy Bar Brown. But right. What I'm talking,
talking
about
Candy Bar Brown
is talking
attractive.
About the 5150 chat room.
They're talking about how they look.
These beasts. Niggas is in wheelchairs. The beasts. I forgot.
Oh,
did you, hey, did you get them pictures? Yeah, I'm going to pull from
Twitter. Who said that?
Somebody Gooch said Rihanna looks like Jam Master Jay.
What?
What the fuck is wrong with what Gooch? Is
J-A-Y out of letters of her name.
Scratch it out of S-B-7's game.
Umbrella.
My forehead an umbrella. Bitch, eyebrows don't never get wet in the rain.
Again, it's just his preference. He doesn't prefer women
no,
with
him. No, fuck that. You can't say Portis and Rihanna in the same fucking
But who did that? No, we weren't talking about that.
They sitting right next to each other right now. They look pretty damn good to me. Both of them. In those two pictures, pretty damn good to me.
You know what's up, but let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. Bitches don't respect that shit you be saying.
I'm just saying.
They know you bullshit.
I'm not bullshitting about the beauty on these pictures.
And I'm going to tell you something. Zones think somebody buying this thirsty ass bullshit.
That's what they
say. Hey, Chris. Just pull up a random picture of Poetess. Just a random picture. Because I ain't saying she ugly.
Yes, I can see
I am not
brain.
Saying Poet is ugly. Poets can get it.
Thank you. That's
but when
all
you
I'm
are,
saying.
When you around a bad bitch, you be like, Poet is, I'm going to teach you later. Call my phone. That's all I'm saying.
I'm not saying there
are. Chris, when you going to put the pictures of the bitches I put up there? This is slow.
Well, nigga, speed up then. Slow ass.
The pressure's on, nigga.
Now what?
Now this is a more challenging.
This is
look.
A realistic look.
This first off is a grainy photo.
She posted it.
It's
up.
Not a high quality photo. I love her haircut.
She looked like in that picture. She looked like the point guard for Maryland. University of Maryland.
He's just so silly. Don't listen to him.
Have you seen the point guard for Maryland? If you did, you wouldn't be saying that.
But I know it's a dude already, Corey.
And she looked just like him in that picture.
Oh, my Lord.
He the point guard. Is it Maryland? Maryland University?
I don't know.
Everybody who in Maryland right now is dying.
No.
They saying in the chat room she can still get it.
Of course she can get it. Dog, niggas will fuck elderly bitches.
You know what? Stop.
That's true. Where are the other pictures you sent? Let's see. What else you got? What else you got, Corey? Because I'm going to tell you right now, that's an attractive woman.
I'm waiting on motherfucking Chris to put up the motherfucking pictures.
Chris is bullshitting over there.
He bullshitting.
That nigga's slow.
We got a show going on, and this nigga ain't got the picture of the bad bitches up.
Get the bad bitches,
picture. He
Chris.
He still got a picture of this motherfucking DMC head bitch who about to steal them motherfucking stripes off her jogging suit.
Off her own suit? Okay.
Y'all send the donations here.
Oh, my God.
You know what? Hope Flood looked pretty good the other night, though.
What?
Bullshit. You didn't think she was attractive, Freeze?
Hell motherfucking no. I keep it 100. Hope? Hell no. I told you that night. I'll tell you right now.
Uh-oh, what night?
We was right there. We did the Coon Train Award.
Yes.
That was big ups, man.
Tariq,
that shit was off the chain.
And now you telling me Rihanna looked like that bitch or this bitch right here?
Hey, listen, hold on.
Wait, You said Rihanna was beautiful. Uh-huh.
All I'm saying is,
okay,
my point still stands. Rihanna, I said there are degrees of beauty.
Wait, so, you put this one up. First of all, they all have
that one on the end look like a hair stink.
So if you're talking about faces or bodies, Corey, because before
faces,
you can't
fry no fish.
Look
at
all they faces,
and that's all a gang of makeup on the first one and this last one. And you sent them. That's all makeup. They do a thing that's called shadowing. Makeup. They do a thing that's called shadowing. It can make their
that
nose
girl in the middle with that chocolate body.
Shading. Oh, that is hilarious, Corey, that you picked those. Even you fell for it.
I didn't fall for nothing.
That's all makeup work right there. That ain't
really?
Yes.
So you telling me.
They even change nose shapes with makeup.
That's true.
I'm not saying nothing about what motherfuckers can do with makeup.
Boy, I saw one.
Corey, one of them ones. Remember how he challenged Bobby? Remember how he challenged Bobby about the trainees? I think Corey will fall for one. Corey, he fell for one. I bet you.
Put them bitches up now. Put Rihanna them up there now.
I want to see what makeup can do for this nose.
But Chris, find a picture of Rihanna like that picture of those.
Get a makeup Rihanna picture. Get the motherfucker made up album cover picture. She ain't fucking with it. Especially, why you got the other bitch? Look at that other bitch that he covering up.
That little Brazilian, Dominican, nice.
What's funny is you won't have anything to do with you guys.
Colombia.
Unless you had like
I
millions.
Fuck all
bitch
would have you come.
You'd
visit
have to pay, and it'd probably be a grip.
You don't have to pay to fuck bitches.
Oh,
you see me again. Now look. You see, you found one with that whole head, that forehead covered with hair. You want to talk about makeup tricks?
But that's called
bundle tricks.
But
that's called a bundle trick.
He called it a whole head.
That is a strategy. She did that with him.
That's a bundle trick.
That's not a strategy. Mm. That is a must.
That girl
stop.
Beautiful, man.
She looks great.
Look,
and that ain't even one of the best pictures I've seen of her. Chris, boy.
I know. That isn't. That's a nice one, though.
Chris found one where he covered a forehead.
That boy, she
leaves it a little mysterious.
Because if she show that forehead,
you know there's a lot of forehead over here that
who
you're not seeing.
About a forehead is so minor compared
if
to
she,
this whole scheme of things.
Usually foreheads are minor, but when they are a major forehead,
oh Lord,
this bitch is on the American Dad side of the game.
she's a good
all right, my forehead isn't that big. All right,
that girl's a dime. Y'all know it.
Yeah.
All right, fuck it.
Imagine if she had on one of them Rasta hats and it was pulled down and then she revealed that. You'll really be mad at that for
him.
He
would not care.
How'd you get under all of that there?
Y'all motherfuckers can't put the pictures up fast enough. You ain't got the bitches I showed you next
Bring
to
up
her.
The pictures, man.
Can you put the bitch next to her?
Yeah. Let's see what we got.
Any one of them bitches. You can't see her face.
That chocolate girl, though. God damn.
Can you get the other bitches?
Right there. Let's see if we got a little comparison here.
Okay. You want me to tell you why that girl can show her head?
Why?
Because it ain't warped. Rihanna got the fetus head.
That's all it is the head
shape. The foreset.
Don't even put it with that bitch with the boots.
Hey, blow her up. Blow the girl up with the boots.
That bitch with the
boots. This is a very beautiful woman right here.
You're seeing the body.
But Rihanna is.
The body? Look at the face.
I think Rihanna is prettier.
Her forehead ain't. You think Rihanna prettier than her?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, well, fuck it. You can take all that shit.
Exactly.
Down.
See?
Rihanna's gorgeous, boy.
I don't know.
Rihanna got more money than them.
Oh, here we go.
It ain't just money.
God.
I just think Rihanna's more pretty.
If you're already pretty, like you said, naturally pretty, why would they need a game of money? Shouldn't have to.
All them sisters was bad, man. Are you crazy?
Right.
Fuck out of here. You put Poetess in the class with them bitches. If Poetess was standing next to them bitches, she better have a motherfucking, what they call them motherfuckers who be working on set?
Set dresser?
No. The errand boys, but they got a name
a
for
PA?
It. Right.
You think
Poetess look like a PA next to them bitches.
Poetess could be right in
that
group.
Can you go give
group?
Me some tea?
Yes.
I'm going to steal your tea.
You think Iva LaShawn is bad?
Who is that?
Show him Iva LaShawn. Iva LaShawn is bad.
I heard of that. Who is that?
She's a comedian. Light-skinned girl, Iva LaShawn.
I know Iva LaShawn. Iva LaShawn is cute. What's the latest picture?
Cute?
She ain't get big.
He's rough.
No, Iva LaShawn.
This one right here.
This one right here is
Hold on.
Rough.
Hold on. Since you put me on the spot, I'm saying I know Iva LaShawn is attractive.
It's bad.
Iva LaShawn is so attractive, she had a lot of opportunities in Hollywood to do big things. Yeah. Because motherfuckers wanted to smash. What happened?
Who Bam.
Zoe said that earlier today. That's her? Oh, shit. You done fucked it up. She looks like Portis in that motherfucker.
Chris just finds the worst pictures ever. But look at that humpity dumpity.
Look at that fucking sway back. She looks like
a... Stop. I can't with you guys.
Oh, my God. Hey, hey. That's the chicken look.
She looked like somebody auntie in that one picture.
Take that picture down. Get a good picture, boy.
Which one? The one on the right? Oh, you guys are way too critical. Oh, my God.
I think she's beautiful.
Look, it don't matter if bitches are beautiful. I'm just saying, bitches are overrated. Rihanna is overrated.
Somebody sending me a picture saying this is beauty, Zoe Williams. Let me see what picture they showed me.
It's going to be a nigga.
Stop. Too crazy.
What the fuck is that? I know ain't no, didn't no nigga send you that picture. Yeah. You playing, Zoe. Ain't nobody send you that picture.
I promise you. This is on Instagram right here. This is.
Who is the nigga who sent that
Stop.
Picture?
It's his take on this beauty. That's fine.
You right, Zoe. You right, D. It's his take on beauty.
Come on.
This motherfucker sent a picture of a bitch who looked like she worked in the high school lunchroom. Keep the line moving. We ain't gonna even put that bitch up there. We
hey,
wasted
Shaki.
Enough time with this shit. The chicken, the who? Mm-hmm. Now let me show you. Let me show you a bitch who you ain't gonna say is beautiful.
Let though. Me see.
Put that bitch up there, Chris.
Oh, stop.
Yeah, say she's beautiful.
I
man.
Can't.
I wanna hear that shit.
Hey, but she is living her sexy though. She is confident. You can see that. She's emanating confidence. She's strong.
That bitch looks like she reaching for a gun like a motherfucker.
Oh, stop. She's
and I done told
selfie.
These motherfuckers to keep that door closed. They think I'm bullshit.
That's her voice? No.
That's my goddamn voice. That
somebody
voice.
Said, Shaba.
No, stop it.
Yeah, may I go and get my gun. I get my pistol. I'm stop a bust it. A shot on that door. My toilet.
Anyway.
Whoever that bitch is.
God damn.
Whoever that bitch is, man. Tell that bitch don't ever take a picture for the internet again.
It ain't for you, Corey, what purpose. She said. She's like,
hey,
it
but the question
you,
is, if you never saw her face and you just saw her
oh,
body would
you
still smash?
But now you already see, you can't.
Look at
to me, she
face.
Had the boy booty, but you couldn't
Wait,
see
what?
It.
No, because it's a weird angle.
What?
Look it was a weird
Freya.
Angle.
She had the boy.
Look at Freya,
it was a weird angle. That's...
She had the boy booty.
What is that?
What is that? A little small, narrow and tight?
A little boy booty.
See the ass of a 13-year-old man.
Right.
That's 13-year-old boy. Whatever.
What the fuck is going on, man?
It wasn't a woman's buttocks.
Oh, my God. She looked like Nina Simone. Who said that?
Oh.
That's fucked up. Don't disgrace Nina Simone.
Not the legend.
Somebody said that. Look.
Not
back
the
it
legend.
Up.
That
they
bitch
did.
Looked like a pirate.
No.
Sidney Poitier's son.
That's terrible, you guys.
It's the Tibbs Jr.
That bitch looks like Antoine Fisher.
No, that's not right.
Damn.
Shit. Raj from What's Happening, nigga, with a thong on. Just
that's horrible.
Anyway, look, it's after 10, so you want to start talking about where you're going to be at this weekend? And you let folks know that you're not... Wait, I'm trying to help us keep on track. Hello? Anyway, Corey, you weren't feeling too well, right? Because a lot of folks were asking about the game.
I was sick.
All right, there you go. See? So they wanted
Bobby
to know.
Schmurda.
They wanted to know what happened to the game.
I'm off, I really am fucked up. It's just I got geeked up for the show. But I'll be better next week. I don't stay down long and shit. So we playing next week for show?
You ready?
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I'll be ready.
I think you needed this extra week of training. What Corey's not telling y'all is he's literally, seriously training. Skateboarding.
That's not true.
Riding bikes, swimming, jump roping. This nigga doing it all. He trying to get his win together. Am I lying, Chris? Is this nigga training, Chris?
Archery. Badminton.
Right.
Ping pong.
He said this nigga's doing art.
Caroms.
Ping pong.
Anything. I gotta get active, I tell you.
Right.
Somebody got you skateboard. Rowing.
This nigga's doing all types of shit.
Yeah, I skateboard. That ain't shit.
Roller skating in Venice? Come on now.
Ain't no skateboard powerful enough to carry his ass all the way to Venice.
I can't lie, but Cayenne them can lie and shit. Dr. Cayenne.
What are you talking about?
The bitches with little books. He don't bust they bubble.
Hey!
I'm supposed to be his homeboy.
You are the homie.
He bust my bubble.
I got to take you to task on the court. You don't respect my game.
I'm going
to
beat the shit out of you,
You going to respect this game when it's all over.
I'm going to make it look bad, too.
Now, when you lose.
Then you going to be working out.
All I want to know is when you lose, you going to humble out?
Dog, I'm going to beat the shit out of you, man.
I'm just saying, when you lose.
I ain't
going to
shoot
lose,
all jump shots. I tell you that much.
You got to go in the paint.
I'm going to do whatever I got to do to beat the shit out of you.
I'm telling you, I ain't going to let you score.
How you going to stop me, Zoe?
Pray I can stop you.
All right.
All right.
We going to see.
I'm going to get my motherfucking Broner on. I'm going to stop him.
Broner?
Uh-oh.
You know what Broner said? I'm going to stop him.
Didn't sound too good.
What happened?
Yeah, that did.
He stopped him. He stopped him. He stopped Theo Payne.
That's that fight.
I'm going to stop you.
I'm like, what is Broner?
Zoe, you too little. I didn't see
Broner.
I know, but it's, I didn't know.
I didn't see you play, Zoe. You got that
Corey,
soft
you
ass
think
game.
You gonna locomotive me. I know what he's gonna try to do.
What is
Bobby
that?
Told me. Oh. Bobby said he's gonna run you over. He gonna try to break your bones, Zoe.
He's taking coaching on from Bobby because you're facing a match with Corey.
No, Bobby is trying to get in. Bobby want to play. He wanted to say he got some sponsors. You know, Bobby want a game.
Want people to drink
Cajun Water Classic.
Yeah, he's the Cajun Water Classic. That's what Bobby doing.
Drink Cajun Water or the old ass tab bottles.
Corey, I have. Let me just tell you, Corey, I have a strategy to beat you. I'm not going to reveal it here.
No, you're too little.
Watch.
I'm not going to take any shots. I'm just going to run around the court dribbling.
This is going to be that 63rd.
Until you pass out.
63rd and Hayes ball. Uh-oh. Everybody from Chicago know what I'm talking about.
What kind of ball is that?
We're going to feel each other.
That's what she said.
We're going to feel each other.
Is R. Kelly going to be there? What the fuck, nigga? We playing who? What are we doing?
I'm going to be all jump shots this game, motherfucker.
I'm going to beat you, dog. It's really simple.
Too little, dog.
What did
they say?
The Kagan Olympics. Bobby will be there. We're going to have Bobby come out with the T-shirt.
Bobby, tell Bobby I'll pay him to wear that motherfucking go-go gadget coat he be wearing.
He had it on the other day, Bobby.
Stop. No, I can't. So going to tell Uncle.
I don't get it.
Kobe Jones.
Oh no, I didn't. Yeah, no. I didn't get it. Thanks. No. Good job. Okay, all moving on.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, and next week I won't have this flu bug, but it's all good, man. So fuck it.
Somebody all said right. Corey look focused. You focused, Corey?
I'm fucked up actually. That's why. Can't you see? Don't y'all
see
how lethargic I am?
Yeah, and something doesn't look right with his skin.
You're more sloth like today.
Oh my god! And you know a sloth.
He's got a nigga.
By the way, Corey, I don't know if you know anything about sloths, but they don't have an asshole, so they secrete all their crap throughout their skin.
What?
She
what
kind
of fucking animal is that?
No, it's true. You didn't
Everything
know that?
Everything on the planet has an asshole.
No, it doesn't. It secretes all its nastiness right
ever
out of his body.
Ever since D did that movie with Eddie Murphy, that 48-hour movie, she been real cocky.
Wait, what?
What movie?
D did that movie, 48 Hours, the first one.
He was in that movie?
No.
He was in that movie?
You talking about the one with Denzel? Oh, he's really high on something.
48 man. Hours?
Eddie Murphy movie.
No.
Yeah, 48 Hours with Nick Nolte.
Y'all didn't see D?
No.
Oh, he's trying to make a joke. Oh, who are you trying to refer? Who are you trying to reference me to, though, Corey?
D was in that movie.
I don't know. He's trying to make some kind
what,
of joke.
What was her part?
Yeah.
She was Gann's homeboy.
God.
Billy Bob.
The big Indian
Billy
dude.
Bob. Oh, he's loving that.
Where's Gans?
With your jolly laugh.
She was in that movie Predator,
laugh.
Too, goddamn.
Billy Bear. Billy Bear.
Give me a way out of this shithole. The only way out, Major, is through this group of trees. But I wouldn't trust that on a broke dick dog. Oh,
she just had they dubbed her voice, but that was D.
That was D.
So funny. Oh.
Billy Bear. There's
something out there, Major. And it ain't so no man. We're all going to die.
That's funny that guy said that. No, not you. I was saying that guy said on there. No, he said, somebody said that I look like Judge Lance Ito from the OJ trial, but I already said before that that's what I used to say to my son when he was first born, because he looked, at the time, OJ was going through the trial, and my son looked like Lance
Ito. Looked like Optimus Prime and Pocahontas made a baby.
Well, at least we look human. At least I look human.
Pocahontas Prime.
And not a blob.
Damn. God damn, Corey.
Get it. Oh, y'all lucky.
You started
it. It wasn't just the word. She gave the delivery.
She's a little blob.
That's your sloppy sounds. Your sloppy ass.
Damn.
Now, you remember what you said you was going to do when you lose this game.
Yeah, uh-oh. I'll take my hat off.
For a month.
For four shows, yeah. That's if I
without
lose.
The touch up.
But nigga.
Without the touch up.
No, he got to let it get shaved. He ain't going to show that head.
Let me tell you something. A month if in the hair. If you lose, what are you going to do?
A month in the hair, his head will look like the top of the Predator head. He'll take what? The helmet off.
Okay, see, he's avoiding the question.
He called
was,
this nigga a blob biscuit. Anyway, what all are right. you going to do?
Yeah.
Well, you we lose. Just got to think of something fair that's compromisable to you showing your head
I don't
before
mind
show.
Showing my head.
Well, take the head off now.
Oh, I got it.
Ha!
See? I got Corey. He's like,
now what, nigga?
I have Corey's. I have Corey's.
It looks like you stole a white dude's head and put it on your head.
I do. I have Corey's. Now. I have Corey's, though.
What
is your gigantic
I
ass
do before it gets do. Any before it gets any later. I have it and I actually
I ain't scared to do shit.
So. Oh,
I want
really?
You come in here dressed like CC Sabathia, nigga.
I was just gonna say the ultimate Corey needs to wear a dress.
Oh, come on. Yeah, no, I ain't gonna do that.
See, damn it, but that's the only fair. Thing. See? Oh.
Shut your hot dog ass.
Oh. Right, that ain't
good one, good one, Chris.
Shit.
You gotta let Chris blow on your head.
Oh, that's great.
Right on the top move. Of your head. We're gonna have an emergency standing by so they can keep
damn
you
it,
cool.
Damn it, so no dress. All right.
That's all I'm saying.
Get it
over.
Ain't
gotta worry about me. I ain't gonna lose. I'll put the house on this.
Don't do that.
Uh-oh.
Chris, I mean, Zoe, you're too little. Dog.
No,
I see
don't,
you play.
Hey, don't do that.
Here I'm not going to let you get the ball back.
Listen, don't put
I'm
anything.
I'm going to beat the shit out of you,
are
boy.
Are we going to have people
don't
there?
Put anything significant.
Are we going to have people there?
Where's the gym we playing at?
First off, nigga, you're talking to the nigga who already beat you. Please understand that. You're talking to a guy who's already beat you.
But it was outdoors.
You can't talk so much shit coming from a space of losing. Okay? Oh. If you've already lost the game, you humble yourself out and you get a chance to play the champ again.
In Culver City, that's right. Yeah.
What is the name of the gym?
Veteran Park. It's right on the corner
what
of.
What time
what is
we
that?
Playing?
Overland and.
4:00. 4:00.
It's on what? Overland and.
I'm.
I know where it's
there.
At.
Why are we giving out the address on air? We're going to have a whole bunch of niggas in there.
I want everybody to see you get your ass whooped.
It ain't going to happen.
Bad.
Ain't going to happen.
You ain't going to get the ball back.
Ain't.
When you miss,
gone.
It's over.
Mm-mm. Happen.
Mm-mm. I'm not giving you the ball back.
Ain't gonna happen.
Too little, though.
Me
I
and Mimi coming.
Play.
We're gonna be cheerleaders.
I love Mimi. That's gonna motivate me to play hard.
There you go.
Y'all wear mini skirts?
Tennis skirts.
Yeah.
What is that? That's high too, right?
Yeah. Yes. Got a little bounce to it.
Bring Mimi for real.
Little Mimi and Bounce.
You got any more hags you can bring?
Shut your... Yeah. You know what?
Bring a noose.
Shut your wide body self.
So we can have a halftime horn.
Oh, Escalade. Oh, UConn built, nigga. I'm telling you, I'm going to beat this dude like I did before.
You know what? You better cut that just because you and George Lopez have the same nose.
Ooh. Don't do it.
I don't give a fuck
I
about my
nose. I love George Lopez, though.
She going
my
ham.
Nose. I like my nose. Shit,
well, you over here making fun of Zone. I mean, of Noosh.
What?
No, I was just saying.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
That wasn't funny, Chris.
Yeah.
You about to lose your call out power. Mm-hmm.
Look at this, y'all. No, nigga.
Anyway.
Right. All right, well, fuck it. We're going to go.
Corey started it.
Oh, that's okay. I ain't tripping on shit. I'm going to beat the shit out of Zoe. That's the first thing of our business.
Gone.
Ain't.
Happen.
No. Half. Seven.
Just like the last time, your cholesterol will catch up with you during the game.
Shoot, here we go. Okay,
you talk that shit.
Here we go. All right. All right.
I'm going to put you on the bench. I know he going to try to shave that head so clean.
Nigga, I am Qui-Gon
that
Chain.
Line of nothing. It's like when you driving to San Diego. It's like when you look on the side, the you be like, that ain't shit out there.
Of nothing.
You know you on the side of the ocean. You be it ain't shit out there. When it's black. Even though you can't see, you be like, damn, there ain't no lights or nothing. Up top, I don't give a fuck. Don't match that shade. They ain't got a razor that sharp.
Listen here.
To cut where the misses
okay,
and the
okay, you guys. God, that,
geez. You're going to lose again, Corey.
Here we go.
Hey, you see this part right here?
Here we go.
It's the top of your head. Look.
The bottom half of your body can't support the top half. I know this.
Uh-oh.
Okay, you're going to topple over.
Uh-oh.
We've seen you fall before. You waddler. We've seen you. Okay?
We can play tonight okay. Now. We really want to talk that shit.
Nigga, that ain't nothing, nigga.
Nigga, we can go play tonight.
I got on jeans, nigga, and play you and beat you.
He does too.
We can play tonight.
No, let's wait and let's make it loud. Let's invite people.
Corey got on some Raider pants.
You know, some hammer pants, nigga.
Right. Raider hammer pants. Raider time.
What was that song we made, the hammer song, in Oakland?
You can't suck dick.
Right.
Oh, my Lord.
Can't suck dick. Yeah. We're going to have a good time, man.
All right, so next week will be the last week Zoe get to talk shit because he's going to get obliterated and made to be...
So let people know. Well, there'll still be a show, though, right? We're gonna come.
Yeah,
back.
We're gonna come back and do the show after I beat the shit out the boy.
Good long travels.
So y'all remember how? Y'all remember how Corey came in here the last time he lost? This nigga was dejected.
But hold on. All I want to ask you is this: so, last time I played you, did I shoot all jump shot?
Yeah.
Okay, that's all I want to say. We're gonna see something different this next.
I want to see you try to get a layup off. I know you can't get, but. 3 to 4 inches off the ground. I saw you.
Mm.
You not bouncy no more.
Hold on. Now remember this part right here, what he said. Corey can only get 3 to 4 inches off the ground. Remember he said that.
I said that.
Hi.
Okay. Chris, film this nigga's feet.
Make sure all next right. Week, y'all remember Zoe said, that's I want to play the slow motion. I got you. I've been skateboarding, nigga.
Oh my
leg strength is coming back, nigga.
Yeah.
I'm going to show you. It's going to be a difference.
All right. Like,
the force is strong on this one.
All right.
Fuck it. We finna go because D got to get up
what?
Out of here.
No, I don't. Fun. I was just trying to keep it decent. Look, it's 10:25. That's all.
Right, we finna go. Yeah. All right. Freeze, what you got? You got something? Pittsburgh Improv. I see y'all Friday, Saturday, Sunday, goddammit.
Mm.
I'm going to be practicing at that Dave and Buster's next door my shot.
And West Haven, Connecticut, on the 23rd of April. Check me out. At, let me tell you the club. Hold on.
Nice.
At the Lotus Lounge.
All right.
I'm going to be there. It's on Boston Post Road in West Haven.
with my man Cool Mike Ski. What up? About to be in New York. About to be a lot of stuff in New York. So y'all come check me out. New York, Jersey, Connecticut. Who knows? Might even dip down to Philly. Who knows?
Nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Why not? Get the breath burger from Chris.
Oh, shit. April 27th, Kentucky State University. I will be there. If you're in the Kentucky State area, please come out. Mm. I'm doing a lecture at Kentucky State University April 27th. I think the program starts at 6 p.m. Also, we just launched another Indiegogo page for the crowdfunding of my latest book project, The Holographic Relationship. Just Google Zoe Williams Holographic Relationship and donate. And The Relationship Dismount, that book is still out and still doing well. If you haven't gotten it, you can get it from iTunes, iBooks, Kindle, or you can go to my website, I Am Zoe Williams, and order a copy right now. I'll mail it out to you personally, a physical copy. But that's what's anxious. Happening with me. D?
I'm laughing at these comments. I'm not anxious, sillies. Yeah, like I said, my book, Definition of Down, if you haven't received it yet and you're... You'd rather listen to my voice in a car or in your, you know, on your computer. Voice. You can get it on the audio version next week. So, all
right. So that's what's up, y'all. Next week will be a more vibrant show as I won't be under weather.
I do feel bad.
And I will be fresh off my victory, off beating the shit.
And anybody local?
Out of Stephen.
Come through.
No Top Curry.
Oh.
She's about to go home and have a nice warm bowl of hamburger soup.
Oh, is that what Corey eats?
He's going to have some hamburger soup.
He's going to have some shepherd's pie that he's going to climb into and nice eat from the inside out.
No Shears Needed. That's the name of Zoe's new book.
No Shears.
No Shears Needed is Zoe's new
book. He's just going to climb into a giant cauldron. Oh, my God. I'm going to eat my way out of this comfort bowl. Right.
Just some tan skin.
Right. The haircut dismount.
You got it. You just need some tan skin.
I use that tan skin.
You better, boy. That disc is going to save your life.
Yeah, man.
The haircut dismount is coming out by Zoe Williams.
Haircut dismount.
Beef sweat over here.
Oh, God, you guys.
I'll tell your barber it's over.
Do you want to not have another line in a day of your life? No, I'm just fucking
Oh, God.
Anyway.
He's got a Snickers stew.
Stop it.
He's going in on your big ass.
Oh,
he's sick.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, I want a Twix burger. It's fatty.
Twix burger. Okay, nigga. I got you, nigga.
All right. Next week, if there's anybody local in the Culver City area, come say hi.
You can watch The Incredible Edible Egg Get Blew Out. Like a motherfucker.
On that, you know what? Okay.
Motherfucker about to get the dog shit stoked out his ass at the basketball court. Remember I said it.
Signifying, that's what we doing.
Show this boy what strength does on the basketball court.
Hey, man, come with it.
All right, little
come
boy.
Come with it.
I got you.
Come with it.
Next week, Hulk Hogan.
Uh-oh.
Hey, brother, I'm about to wear my do-rag in court. So we got a do-rag for you to play Corey in.
Bulk Hogan, more like. No, not the Hulk. Bulk Hogan.
Bulk Hogan against the Ball Eagle.
Right. I'm gonna take you down. I'm coming for you, nigga.
Oh my God. Anyway, bandana, no bandana. All
right. Hey, we out of here, Nick. Oh, top of Zoe head.
Uh oh.
Yeah.
All right, fuck it. We up. I'ma holler. Peace.